bud. You're not sweating today.
A little cooler today.
Yeah. What is it?
McNeil's not going today.
Not.
Steven Ross in place.
He's moving down to tackle.
Yeah, to tackle.
That's fine, as long as Charlie can see it.
Yes.
Can you, Vinny, like you get on headset, Chris?
He just knocked himself out hitting the power grid back there.
Charlie, if you either that or put it on top of it, Charlie.
No, that's fine right there.
Can you see it?
Yeah. I don't need to see too much.
All right.
Now I know you can see it because you normally write about that big.
That looks better.
Not quite a naked.
Okay.
And you might want to side up a little bit.
Snug it up there, big dog.
Snug it up.
Like a chin strap.
There you go.
All right, Charlie, my first question is, what kind of effect can Jackie Sherrill's announcement have on today's game?
Okay.
Do we need to move over and not have this camera in the background?
That might be a good idea. I'm not looking inside of it.
Yeah.
You have a good week?
Yeah. How about you?
Had a good week.
Good.
He had team meetings on Wednesday and Thursday, right?
What's that?
Jackie Sherrill. Did he meet with the team?
I don't know. It was announced yesterday.
Yeah, no, he met with the team. Yeah, I think he did. Let him know. Came out on the internet.
We heard about it from ESPN.
Yeah. What's his, in 13 years, what's his record against Auburn?
Notes.
I didn't see that.
Where's Auburn's notes? Versus
see, it doesn't have it.
Sure doesn't. Surely it's in their notes.
Well, it
doesn't. I think he's 7-6, Charlie.
Okay. No, this is his 13th year. That's 13. Can't be 7-6. He'd have to be 6-6 or 7-4 and 5. It doesn't matter. We won't bring that up.
sunshine-drenched Jordan-Hare Stadium, where today the Auburn Tigers, ranked number 19 in the Associated Press poll, face the Mississippi State Bulldogs in a key Southeastern Conference Western Division battle. With former Auburn quarterback Charlie Trotman, I'm Andy Burchett. Well, Charlie, big news yesterday, Jackie Sherrill announcing that he'll retire effective at the end of the season. What kind of effect can that have on today's ballgame?
Well, I don't think it was really a surprise that Jackie Sherrill is resigning or retiring actually at the end of the season, Andy. I think the timing of his announcement's a bit surprising. I think he's trying to give his team a little bit of a motivational edge coming into the game against Auburn. They started out with a really bad season, 0-4,
right,
but they come out with two wins over Vanderbilt and Memphis, and Kevin Fant, their quarterback, and we'll talk about in a minute,
right,
is having an excellent season in the last, at least in the last two games especially. And I think Jackie Sherrill's announcement will give them some motivation, but Andy, it really won't carry much weight after the game starts.
From an offensive standpoint, this is a different Mississippi State team. Charlie, as you mentioned, Kevin Fant has been on fire throwing the football for the Bulldogs.
Oh, he really has. Kevin Fant, he's a 6'2", 205-pound senior quarterback. He's really been around a long time. He's got over 5,000 passing yards, had over 300 yards and three touchdowns against Houston earlier in the season. Last week, 245 yards passing, threw the ball over 35 times, and had two touchdowns against Memphis. He's really coming to his own. Kevin Fant is not going to be a running threat, Andy. He is going to hang in there in the pocket, and he's going to throw the ball downfield, and he's
really
got some weapons.
Yeah, really will test Auburn's secondary, and a guy that has been Mr. Versatile back there is Junior Rose Green.
Yeah, now Junior Rose Green, he's out of Dillard High School. Auburn's got a big link with Dillard High School, and he's the trash talker of the defensive backs. And Junior Rose Green can play cornerback. He's taken over for Carlos Rogers in the last couple of weeks. He's been very valuable. Had a huge fumble recovery against Arkansas to stop a drive that would have been possibly a tying touchdown in the later stages of that game last week. Junior Rose Green, a big factor in Auburn's defense.
Should be a great one today. Auburn and Mississippi State will have the first half play-by-play when we return. Press poll, face the Mississippi State Bulldogs in a key Southeastern Conference Western Division battle. With former Auburn quarterback Charlie Trotman. Are you guys all right with it? I'm okay with it. All right, good deal.
Where's
one. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4. Didi at left safety. Junior's going to corner today. Junior's going to corner for Kevin Hobbs. I think he'll play.
Tiger fans, we remind you, Jordan Hare Stadium is designated as a smoke-free seating area. Smoking is allowed on the outer concourses and exit ramps only. We appreciate your cooperation. Also today, when you visit Jordan Hare's concession stands, be sure to ask for your Coca-Cola in the official 2003 Auburn Souvenir Cup, available at all Jordan Hare concession stands. For your comfort, safety, and medical care, East Alabama Medical Center has provided a first aid station located behind Section 46. Should a medical emergency occur in your seating area, direct your attention to the stadium ushers. We ask your cooperation with the staff and medical professionals who will assist you. And now please direct your attention to the video board in the south end zone for a special presentation. Last season, the Auburn women's basketball team captured the Women's National Invitation Tournament Championship. The Tigers, who finished the season 23-12, won the 64-team tournament with wins over South Alabama, Florida State, Richmond, and Creighton. The Tigers captured the WNIT Championship at Baylor with a 64-63 win over the Bears. And now, introducing members of the 2003 WNIT Championship team. Presenting the 2003 championship rings is the Director of Athletics, David Household. Tournament Most Valuable Player, Natasha Brackett. Natasha Brown. Nancy Herrick. Louise Namagi. Akeisha Johnson. Diana Lorza, Nicole Loudon, Tia Miller, Marina Payne, Tiffany Presley, Mendeza Stevenson, Nicole Willingham, the managers Chris Reisman and Chris Wolf, Sam Purcell, student athletic trainer Julie King, athletic trainer Jared Grace, the director of basketball operations Samantha Tomlinson, assistant coaches Loretta Freeman, Craig Kennedy, and the head coach entering his 25th season, Joe Tappy. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2003 WNIT champion, Auburn Tigers. singing the Auburn alma mater. The words will be shown on the video screen above the south end zone. Today, the alma mater will be conducted by former Auburn drum major Craig Arhus, who is now assistant director of bands at Mississippi State University.
Stand up and holler! side over here to be Auburn. I want this side to be Tigers. Auburn!
Sunshine-drenched Jordan-Hare Stadium, where today the Auburn Tigers, ranked number 19 in the Associated Press poll, face the Mississippi State Bulldogs in a key Southeastern Conference Western Division battle. With former Auburn quarterback Charlie Trotman, I'm Andy Burchett. Well, Charlie, big news yesterday, Jackie Sherrill announcing that he will retire effective at the end of the season. What kind of effect can that have on today's ballgame?
Well, I don't think it was really a surprise that Jackie Sherrill is resigning or retiring actually at the end of the season, Andy. I think the timing of his announcement's a bit surprising. I think he's trying to give his team a little bit of a motivational edge coming into the game against Auburn. They started out with a really bad season, 0-4, but they come out with two wins over Vanderbilt and Memphis, and Kevin Fant, their quarterback, that we'll talk about in a minute, is having an excellent season in the last, at least in the last two games especially. And I think Jackie Sherrill's announcement will give them some motivation, but Andy, it really won't carry much weight after the game starts.
From an offensive standpoint, this is a different Mississippi State team. Charlie, as you mentioned, Kevin Fant has been on fire throwing the football for the Bulldogs.
Oh, he really has. Kevin Fant, he's a 6'2", 205-pound senior quarterback. He's really been around a long time. He's got over 5,000 passing yards, had over 300 yards and three touchdowns against Houston earlier in the season. Last week, 245 yards passing, threw the ball over 35 times, and had two touchdowns against Memphis. He's really coming to his own. Kevin Fant is not going to be a running threat, Andy. He is going to hang in there in the pocket, and he's going to throw the ball downfield, and he's really got some weapons.
Yeah, really will test Auburn's secondary, and a guy that has been Mr. Versatile back there is Junior Rosegreen.
Yeah, now Junior Rosegreen, he's out of Dillard High School. Auburn's got a big link with Dillard High School, and he's the trash talker of the defensive backs. And Junior Rosegreen can play cornerback. He's taken over for Carlos Rogers in the last couple of weeks. He's been very valuable. Had a huge fumble recovery against Arkansas to stop a drive that would have been possibly a tying touchdown in the later stages of that game last week. Junior Rosegreen, a big factor in Auburn's defense.
Should be a great one today. Auburn and Mississippi State will have the first half play-by-play when we return. Stadium, Auburn and Mississippi State this afternoon. Auburn will receive the opening kickoff. A gorgeous afternoon for football. I'm telling you what, this is what the fall football season's all about, Charlie Trotman.
The humidity is low, Andy. The sun is bright. It's a sun-soaked Jordan-Hare feel. Auburn in their home blue uniforms against the dark maroon pants and white jerseys of Mississippi State. Beautiful setting for college football. If you're an Auburn fan and you're here, or even if you're a visiting fan with the Mississippi State Bulldog contingent, a wonderful atmosphere to be a part of.
In his fifth season at Auburn, his ninth season in the league, Tommy Tuberville, his record at Auburn is 34-21 as a head coach in this league, 59-41. And on the other side, Jackie Sherrill announcing that he will retire at the end of this season, the Dean of SEC Head Coaches, in his 13th season in Starkville. And really, Charlie has done a remarkable job with that Mississippi State program.
Well, he has. He's had them in the SEC Championship game, very close to beating Tennessee the year Tennessee won the national championship. Jackie Sherrill, the Dean of SEC Coaches, saying this week that he is not going to continue at Mississippi State.
Beautiful day, 68 degrees, humidity of just 52%. Winds out of the north and northeast at 5 miles an hour and just a couple clouds in the sky. It's really a beautiful day for football here this afternoon. Auburn lost the toss. The Tigers will receive the opening kickoff here this afternoon. And special teams, Charlie Trotman, Mississippi State, since Jackie Sherrill has been in Starkville, have always been known as a very good team with special teams.
Oh, they have great special team personnel, too. Now, of course, they're going to kick the ball off to Auburn. Auburn's got Trey Smith, Carnell Williams back, two excellent kick returners. But I tell you what, Fred Reed had a 100-yard kickoff return, only the second 100-yard kickoff return in the series in Mississippi State football history against Memphis last week.
Auburn has dominated the series. 55 wins, 22 losses, but of late, State has won its share of games against the Tigers.
And Jackie Sherrill has a pretty good record against Auburn. Tommy Tuberville, 4-4 overall, 2-2 at Auburn.
Carnell Williams off the Brent Smith kickoff will just watch it go out of the back of the end zone, and Auburn will open up first down and 10 at its own 20-yard line. As we take a look up front for the Tigers, and it's a bit of a change, Para Reddick, Lindsey Crittenden, Stephen Ross getting the start today for the injured Marcus McNeil, has just been plagued with back trouble for the last couple of years. Brandon Johnson back at fullback, Carnell Williams, the two-time SEC Player of the Week, Mix McIntyre, and Cooper Wallace is the tight end. And the quarterback for the Auburn Tigers is Jason Campbell, number 17 for the Tigers. Campbell on the season with five touchdowns, three interceptions. He is 77 of 127 on the season. First and 10 from the 20 for Auburn. Out of the shotgun, Campbell locks it up and throws, and the pass is incomplete. Pass intended for Ben Obamano, getting the start today over Courtney Taylor. As you look at the defense for Mississippi State up front, Kelly, Day, Fields, and Delwan Robinson. A good linebacking core for the Bulldogs. And the guy right in the middle, T.J. Mawinney, along with Marvin Birdsong and Jason Clark. And in the secondary for Jackie Sherrill's team, Bradley Culberson Johnson and Kevin Dockery. Auburn out of the eye on second down and 10. The pitch to Carnell Williams with some blockers, tries to cut back and gets 4 yards on the play. Clarence McDougal on the stop and some activity downfield as Ben Obamano got tied up with Quentin Culberson.
Well, Quentin Culberson's a freshman. That was the toss sweep for Carnell Williams. Carnell Williams has had an outstanding 2 weeks, Andy. Over 330 yards rushing in the last two ball games against Tennessee and Arkansas. Two terrific defenses.
Third and five for Auburn. The Tigers 37% on third down this season. Campbell to throw. It's complete. Jairus McIntyre makes one man miss. He's got a first down to the 35. He got past Culberson, and Clarence McDougal had to make the stop.
Nice play with Jairus McIntyre coming up with another big third down conversion. How many big plays has Jairus McIntyre been a part of for Auburn in this early season? Of course, getting into the middle of the season now, but Jairus McIntyre scored that first touchdown against Vanderbilt, had a 67-yard touchdown also against Vanderbilt. He's been big for Auburn.
As good as you're going to find of a guy that gets yards after the catch. First down and 10 for Auburn at the 35-yard line. As Auburn goes to a three-wide set. The handoff goes to Carnell and hit at the line and maybe gets a yard, and that's about all.
Carnell Williams up the middle.
Jason Clark among those getting off the pile for Mississippi State as Williams finds tough going on that first down carry.
And Andy, this defense of Mississippi State has been giving up over 400 yards a game in total offense, and they've really given up a lot of points. They're last in the conference right now, giving up over 34 points a game. And Auburn would love to take advantage of that.
From the 36-yard line, Auburn on second down. The play action and the rollout for Campbell. Looks, he throws, and Cole Bennett-Cahan on the ball. The freshman out of Dalton, Georgia, probably gets a first down, but looked like he started to run upfield before he actually caught the ball, Charlie.
Well, you know, that kind of tells you a little bit about offensive football. If you have anybody on the team that doesn't execute, everybody on the team may have had 10 players executing right there, but Auburn's Cole Bennett, who has a touchdown to his credit earlier in the season against Tennessee, but Cole Bennett right there just did not look that ball in his hand.
Second, third down of this opening drive for Auburn. The Tigers need 9. With time, Campbell throws over the head of Jairus McIntyre at the 50-yard line.
Incomplete.
Well, you got to give the Auburn offensive line a lot of credit. They gave Jason Campbell a lot of time, and he had an open Jairus McIntyre. He just short-armed it a little bit, Andy. Didn't follow through. Threw the ball a little high, and Auburn was lucky that ball wasn't picked off because that was right in the middle of the field.
There's Nick Turner averaging almost 9 yards a punt return. He's the number one guy in the conference in kickoff returns. Standing at his own 22-yard line to take this punt from Cody Bliss, who puts it high and sends Turner back to the 18-yard line. Across the 30 and taken down at the 35-yard line. A fine return that time. 17 yards on the return from Turner after a punt of over 40 yards by Cody Bliss. A look at the defense or the offense for State. They're enormous up front. Burch Rogers, a walk-on in Blake Jones, who's from Athens, Alabama. Davis and Stewart, Donovan Davis. 6'7", 335. Jarius Norwood and Darnell Jones in the backfield. Ray Bivens and the best receiver in the conference, Justin Jenkins. Well, they are Lumpkin at tight end, and the quarterback, of course, is Kevin Fant, who works out of the shotgun on first down. Fant over 1,500 yards, 12 touchdowns, 11 interceptions this season, and intended for Jenkins, but well behind on that slant route there by Jenkins.
And Auburn was coming with a little blitz that time.
Look at the Tiger defense, excuse me, Charlie. Edens, McNeil, Johnson, and Torbor up front. Brett Edens starting for Doug Langenfeld. The linebackers in a good group. Williams, Thomas, and Carlos Dansby. And then Junior Rose Green, Carlos Rogers, Caribbe Didi, and Will Herring in the secondary. You know that bunch is going to be tested this afternoon. Auburn with a five-man front. A handoff to Norwood. Taken down by Carlos Dansby on the play. Dansby, Charlie, came up almost like a defensive end there and was able to knife through and make the tackle.
Well, and on the first play, Carlos Dansby came on a blitz. They're going to try to make Kevin Fant, who's a very experienced quarterback, a senior out of Moss Point, Mississippi, has done a great job during his career, over 5,000 passing yards. He's got a third down conversion right here.
The Bulldogs need 8. 35% on third down this season for Mississippi State. Fant from the gun. Auburn brings the blitz. Fant gets rid of it, complete. Jenkins shy of a first down by a yard. Junior Rosegreen was able to make the stop for the Tigers as Auburn brought Caribbe Didi on a safety blitz.
And Fant got up, Andy, a little bit gimpy with his right arm. He was stretching his right arm, but a nice, effective little slant route. And it's going to, and a great tackle. We talked about Junior Rosegreen, what he means to the Auburn defense, and they stopped him short there.
A yard shy of the first down, so Robert Wallace is on to punt it away. Third in the SEC, an average of 44.3 yards per punt. Trey Smith to take this punt from the 8 and across the 10 to about the 12-yard line. Adrian Griffin made the stop. Auburn on its second drive when we come back on CSS and the Auburn Network.
The campus today is Boulder Auburn Tiger versus Washington. Good luck to the season and warrior.
with service assignment. Assistive listening devices are furnished at no cost to the user and may be picked up at a first aid station located behind section 46. Also, large programs are available for those in need and may be obtained at the first aid station and the East Coast.
Opening drives, the Tigers on their second drive will start first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. Quick drop, Campbell throws, it's complete. Breaking away, Courtney Taylor, a first down catch. Darren Wilson, Julian Williams, the strong safety, made the stop as Taylor was able to get away from the first would-be tackler.
And coming into the game, Courtney Taylor and Jairus McIntyre tied to lead Auburn in receiving, had 18 catches coming in, his 19th reception on the season. Nice reception and break of the first tackle. If you can get away from the first defender, you've done your job as a receiver.
16 yards as he got through the tackle of Odell Bradley. Courtney Taylor, first and 10. The pitch to Carnell Williams, trying to get to the outside. Cuts upfield, across the 35. Midfield, Williams cuts it back. One man to beat, he's gone. He is gone. Touchdown! Yards. Carnell Williams to the end zone.
Andy, what can you say about Carnell Williams and how much he means to this team? Saw him carry the ball almost 40 times against Arkansas's defense. He saw that he didn't have a lot inside. He bounced to the outside, and then it was the tackle that he broke, putting his shoulder down and just showing you his explosiveness as he broke back to the middle of the field and got through all of the Mississippi State defenders. Auburn's first score on the afternoon.
Good downfield blocking by Devin Aroma should do as John Vaughn comes on for the extra point. And Auburn, with 10:39 to go in the first quarter, goes 72 yards with Carnell Williams taking it to the end zone. 7-0 Auburn leads. Another look as Carnell Williams goes 72 yards, giving Auburn the touchdown. Good blocking for Auburn downfield. Watch the tackles that Carnell breaks on this run.
Great blocking right there. Just doesn't look like he has anything, Andy. And look what he does. He explodes through the tackle. And it was Clarence McDougal who could not get a good shot on Cornell Williams. Had a solid shot on him, but just couldn't wrap his arms around him because Cornell exploded through that tackle.
Yeah.
Amazing run for the size. You talk about the size of Cornell Williams. You know, a lot of people don't realize he's 5'11", just over 200 pounds, but that looked like a 250, you know, pound. That looked like Brandon Jacobs running the ball instead of Cornell Williams with the weight that he put into that explosion.
Nick Turner, the top kickoff returner in the SEC, not given an opportunity there as Philip Yost put it 8 yards deep in the end zone. So first and 10 for Mississippi State at its own 20-yard line. And Yost, a definite weapon against the great kickoff return artist that State has here this afternoon. A pro eye set for Mississippi State at its own 20. Auburn put six on the line. The pitch to Norwood. Nothing doing for Norwood as he barely gets back to the line of scrimmage. DeMarco McNeil leading the charge for Auburn.
Mississippi State has been very proud of what Jarius Norwood has been able to do, Andy, in the last couple of weeks. He's had good ball games against Vanderbilt, also another good ball game against Memphis last week. But it looks like we've got somebody shaken up, and that may be Norwood, who's still on the turf.
There's DeMarco, who, and it is Norwood, the tailback out of Brandon, Mississippi, just a sophomore. 337 yards coming into this afternoon's action and one touchdown. And Charlie, if we get another look at this as Jackie Sherr looks on, he looked like he lowered his head and maybe butted heads with DeMarco McNeil. Let's get another look at this.
Yeah, Kevin Fan on the toss sweep to the right. A nice block on Brett Eddins out there. And then he just puts his head down a little bit too low.
Yeah.
And Auburn's big DeMarco McNeil with all 300 pounds of him. Goes in there and hits Norwood, who a 6 foot, 192-pound sophomore out of Brandon, Mississippi, and their two tailbacks have had the exact same number of carries, 72 carries. Both tailbacks had Nick Turner and Jarius Norwood coming into the ball game.
Norwood a little woozy as he goes to the sideline, and McNeil, who made the play, comes out, and T.J. Jackson from Opelika, Alabama, steps into the lineup at nose tackle for Auburn. No gain on the play at second and 10. Auburn comes with a safety blitz. Fant rolls and throws. It is incomplete. In and out of the hands of McKinley Scott, who then really took a shot on the play from Auburn. Kevin Sears came over, Auburn's outside linebacker. Watch the hit he puts on McKinley Scott.
Nice throw by Fant. Fant throws the ball exactly where he's supposed to get it to him. And then Kevin Sears, 6'4", 217-pound freshman, just unloads on the Mississippi State receiver, and the ball, it wasn't jarred loose. He never really caught it, Andy. Never had it. Never got a good catch on the ball.
Here's third and 10 for the Bulldogs from their own 20. Short drop, Fant against the blitz. Throws incomplete in the flag. This is likely to be interference on Auburn. Junior Rosegreen got his hands on the ball. But the flag thrown at about the 30-yard line. If it is against Auburn, it's a first down for State.
Looks like it's going to be an early hit on Junior Rosegreen, but this is great combo coverage on the great receiver, Justin Jenkins, who leads the conference. And Auburn's going to get called and flagged Junior Rosegreen with the interference. But they had Auburn's number 11, Carlos Dansby, going out and trying to take the slant away. Junior Rosegreen coming over the top, and he just hit Jenkins a little bit too early in it.
It is first down for Mississippi State. Doyle Jackson, the referee here this afternoon. Play action, Fant looking, throwing, incomplete, trying to go to the fullback, Darnell Jones. Good to see Carlos Rogers back out there for Auburn after he missed the Arkansas game last week in Fayetteville. You can see that he's still got a cast on that left hand, that left thumb that he broke in the Tennessee game prior to the big interception.
Yeah, has one interception on the year. Didn't look like he was favoring anything. And then we got Dole Jackson calling, throwing a penalty.
And I'll bet this is going to be a legal substitution on Mississippi State.
Could be. They came out of the huddle, and we'll get the call right here. And that's exactly what it is. Illegal substitution on Mississippi State, and that's a good penalty for Auburn because...
Foul is illegal substitution by the offense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot with a repeat of the down.
This is a state team that's averaged penalties 93 yards a game. That's worse than the SEC.
Yeah, but it's also an offense that is fifth in the conference, averaging almost 400 yards a game. And their passing offense, their third, averaging 260 yards a game. So any kind of penalty that'll move them back, you certainly like to see if you're Auburn.
Nose of the football just beyond the 24-yard line. Fant throws incomplete. Tried to get it to Omar Connor, a freshman out of Macon, Mississippi. And that pass was just simply too high to Connor.
Yeah, not a good throw that time by Fant. Uncharacteristic because he's very accurate. But I tell you what, he's been favoring his arm a little bit. And what's happening right now early in the game is Auburn has decided that Gene Chizik, they're not going to give Kevin Fant time to set up and sit and read. They're going to make him throw the ball very early.
He's looking at blitz on almost every passing play so far. Obviously a passing down here on third and 15. Again, Auburn rushes, bad snap, and he goes down. DeMarco McNeil will get the sack. The ball is loose. Who's got it? McNeil will get the sack for the Tigers. He had a sack last week against Arkansas. That's his third of the season.
And Andy, did you see that Doyle Jackson, the referee, actually had Reggie Torber around the collar? Now, what happened is Kevin Fant fumbles the shotgun snap. DeMarco McNeil is in there. He knocks the ball away. There's a scramble for the football, and Mississippi State comes up with it, but there was some tussling in there. Doyle Jackson had to get involved in it.
The punt by Wallace. Short. Trey Smith can return this from the 45. And he fumbles the football. And I think Auburn got the ball back. Heads up play by Auburn, number 42, Brett Holloman. Back up, free safety for the Tigers.
Wow, what a big break for Auburn because they had great field position on the punt return of Trey Smith. And had it not been for a really heads up play by Brett Holloman, the backup free safety, Mississippi State would have had the ball again in great field position. So Auburn gets a break there. The fumble by Trey Smith, but it's recovered on the punt return by Auburn's Brett Holloman.
Charlie, I think David Hurd was trying to pick that up and go the distance for State, and Holloman dove on top of the football, took it away.
Those are the kind of plays in the kicking game that can really impact a football game, and Auburn gets a break there.
From the Mississippi State 47-yard line. Brandon Jacobs in at tailback, play action. Campbell looks, he throws it to Jacobs. Big Brandon Jacobs to the 20 and out of bounds near the 15-yard line. 32 yards on the pickup for Auburn. Kevin Dockery, the free safety, perhaps saving a touchdown for Mississippi State.
I believe that that's the first pass reception on the year for Brandon Jacobs. And Brandon Jacobs shows you what he can do with the football. Just a check down, nothing open downfield. As you see right there, Jason Campbell gets the ball away to Brandon Jacobs. And look at the speed of Brandon Jacobs getting to the outside. That big hoss at 250 pounds can really motor.
Auburn from the State 13 as Mississippi State shows blitz. Brandon Jacobs to the corner, turns it upfield and runs down inside the five. Clarence McDougal makes the stop.
And there's nice blocking on that right side, Andy, because nobody really was able to get out there. Look at the block of Auburn's Brandon Johnson for Brandon Jacobs. Just stymies the defensive end on that side, and a great read of the block. Just heads on around the corner, gets it inside the 5-yard line.
First and goal from the 3 for Auburn as Carnell Williams checks back in at tailback for Auburn. Brandon Johnson is the fullback with Para Reddick, Lindsey Crittenden, and Ross up front for Auburn. Bennett and Cooper, the two tight ends. Jacobs in motion. Carnell Williams slices. Down to the goal line. Did he get in? Yes, he did. It's a touchdown for Auburn.
Well, a big break also, Andy, because Parnell Williams was reaching for the goal line, and the officials were saying that he broke the plane of the goal with an outstretched arm because the ball, when it hit the ground, it popped loose, and Mississippi State recovered it in the end zone. So that play was either going to be a Mississippi State recovered fumble for a touchback or an Auburn touchdown, and Auburn right now getting all the breaks.
Jackie Sherrill looking at the Jumbotron at the replay, and that's exactly what he's saying right now, Charlie. Hey, Auburn's getting all the breaks. Vaughn to attempt the extra point. And Auburn, with 8:09 to go on the first quarter of play, has forged a 14-point lead on Mississippi State. Carnell Williams with his fifth touchdown run of the season.
Good blocking by Big Monrico Crittenden. And as you see Carnell working for that goal line, it's a little block we can't really see as he stretches his arm out to go over the goal line. But the linesman on the right side, on the far side of the field, he was the first one that made the call. And evidently Carnell got the ball across the plane before his knee came down.
Well, all you got to do is break the plane with the football, and afterwards it doesn't matter.
You know, and that's a difference in modern football. Over 20 years ago when I was playing, Andy, they would never have given you a touchdown for that, even though you break the plane. And that's always been the rule now. They've never changed the rule. But if you were down, if your body was down on the one-yard line, you were not allowed to reach over. They were going to make your entire body get over. It was always that way, and it's just changed in the last 15 years or so, and it's changed for the better because that's the way it's supposed to be.
Did you ever lose a touchdown that way?
Oh, sure. Yeah. In 1978, a lot of Auburn fans will remember William Andrews scoring right before halftime on a Georgia team that may have been Sugar Bowl bound, and we ended up tying Georgia that day, and they didn't give us the touchdown that the time ran out of the clock for halftime. And William Andrews his whole body, his upper torso was in, but they said his knee touched early. But certainly the ball was over the plane before his knee touched. So it just is a change, and it's changed for the better. The officials are calling that rule the way it's supposed to be called.
Nick Turner and Fred Reed to return. These are the top two kickoff return guys in the conference. And it will be Turner from a yard deep in the end zone. He is in some trouble. And out to the 15-yard line. Turner averaging almost 27 yards a return with a flag down on the play. Lamel Ages and Andrew Letts, a pair of backup defensive backs for the Tigers, down to make the stop on Turner.
It may be a block in the back here, Andy, but as we find out what Doyle Jackson's going to call, it's going to be a hold against Auburn. Actually, on the kick return for Mississippi State. So I think he signaled a hold toward Auburn, but they're marking it off against Mississippi State.
Well, holding by the returning team.
I was going to say, I've never seen holding on the kickoff team before.
It would have been an unusual call.
By first down.
But the indication was when the linesman started marking the ball off, then you knew it was a Mississippi State penalty and not an Auburn penalty.
And State backed up to its own 8-yard line. Not the kind of start Jackie Sherrill would have wanted for his ball club, down 14 to nothing with 8:01 to go in the first quarter. Fant, the handoff. This is Turner into the open. Turner out to the 23-yard line and a first down. 15 yards on the carry by Nick Turner out of Atlanta, Georgia. Karabee Deedy on the stop for Auburn.
And Don Dunn, Auburn's defensive line coach, Andy, talked about these two guys, Norwood and Turner, and they scare you to death because they have great open field ability. And Karabee Deedy did a good job getting downfield and making an open field tackle. He struggled a little bit tackling the Arkansas backs downfield last week, but Karabee Deedy with a nice open field tackle.
From the 23, first down for Mississippi State. Turner again. Got through the hole again. Turner with one man to beat, and it's a foot race. Kevin Hobbs is giving chase on Turner. And Turner is in, touchdown.
Well, we just talked about it, Andy, about Don Dunn really fearing these two guys. And you see right there the open field ability of Nick Turner, 182-pound sophomore out of Atlanta.
77 yards for Turner and a touchdown.
Nothing more than the stretch play. Auburn gets a couple of people in there turned around. Carlos Dansby and Dontarius Thomas just not able to close the gap. Will Herring had an opportunity to make the tackle, and it's left to Carlos Rogers to see if he could run him down. And Turner's got great speed at 5'10", 182, out of B.T. Washington High School in Atlanta, Georgia. The sophomore puts the Mississippi State Bulldogs on the board.
77 yards for Turner. Parade All-American out of high school, and Brent Smith on for the extra point. It's good. And just like that, the Auburn lead is cut in half. 7:18 remaining in the first quarter of play. Again, Nick Turner going 77 yards for the touchdown.
And see how this opens up. Dontarius Thomas not able to skate over there in time, and Will Herring making the miss on the tackle attempt, and it was all over after that. Really outstanding blocking by a huge offensive line for Mississippi State, and Turner didn't have to do much on that except make one guy miss.
Yeah, Kevin Hobbs was trying to run him down from behind and just was unable to do so. So Turner, who came in for the injured Jarius Norwood, pays immediate dividends for Mississippi State.
Now, these two guys are very similar. Norwood is 192-pound sophomore out of Brandon, Mississippi. Turner, again, 182-pound sophomore out of Atlanta. Both of them are that kind of juke-type back, the guy that wants to make you miss. They're not going to run you over with power. They're a little bit different than Carnell Williams is for Auburn. Carnell is kind of a combination of speed and power. These guys are more finesse running backs, and they're going to make you miss. If they can get creases like that, that's going to give Mississippi State the belief that they can run the ball on this Auburn team, and that's something that Auburn certainly does not want to have to contend with. Kevin Fance enough to have to contend with, much less the running game of the Bulldogs.
Carnell Williams 3 yards deep in the end zone. He'll bring it out. Carnell out to the 20-yard line on the return for Auburn. Gabe Wallace, a backup free safety on the stop for State.
Well, and think about what Auburn had on that last series defensively. They had a hold on the kickoff return. They had Mississippi State backed up inside their 10-yard line to the 8-yard line. And that was a 92-yard drive on just a couple of three plays. And Mississippi State has to be feeling better, because just a moment ago they were down 14-0 on the road. And Auburn's defense was looking very good. And then after the big touchdown run by Turner, they got to be feeling a lot better about their position.
From the 20-yard line, first down for Auburn. Carnell Williams. It's the reverse to Jarius McIntyre with lots of room to go. McIntyre to midfield. 30 yards on the end around for Auburn. Odell Bradley and Marvin Birdsong on the stop.
What a great call. Got to give Auburn the coaching staff and Steve Ensminger and Hugh Nall a lot of kudos for this call, because Auburn running the tall sweep, running the stretch play, running the ball as effectively as they have been, that's the first reverse that I can remember Auburn running the entire season. And when you got a guy like Jarius McIntyre, who's more like a tailback when he's got the football in his hands, you got to get him the ball a couple of times on that reverse. Great play.
Saw number 17, Jason Campbell, leading the blocking downfield for Auburn. Hand off to Carnell to the 45. To the 40, 9 yards on first down for Carnell Williams. Quentin Culberson, a 6-foot freshman out of Jackson, Mississippi, along with Marvin Birdsong on the stop for State.
Kind of what we were talking about, rushing defense. Right now, Mississippi State, 10th in the conference, giving up 156 yards a game. And again, over 474, almost 500 yards a game they're averaging, Andy, giving up on defense. That's a defense that's certainly reeling in most of the contests.
Cooper Wallace, the man in motion for Auburn. The Tigers need a yard on second down. Campbell looking and throwing incomplete to Devin Aromashadu. And Campbell got decked as he was throwing the football by Jason Clark, the Sam linebacker for Mississippi State.
Well, he really did. Clark just unloaded on him. And Jason Campbell is at that very vulnerable spot that quarterbacks find themselves in when they're delivering the ball. You can't really protect yourself. And Clark just unloaded. He goes 245 and all 245 pounds right into Jason Campbell.
Third and one for Auburn. Carnell Williams on the carry. He's got the first down. Williams diving across the 30 to the 29. 11 yards on the carry and a first down for the Tigers.
Boy, and he almost kept his balance right there. Carnell Williams, just the benefactor of great blocking right there. Cooper Wallace, and look at the block of Brandon Johnson. What does that fullback mean to the Auburn running game? Well, Carnell almost able to break that one for the distance.
A week ago when he went out with the bad shoulder, we saw Auburn's ground game halt. Who will forget Georgia a year ago when he went out and what the effect it had on Auburn's ground game? Brandon Johnson giving a rest right now, is Carnell the only one in the backfield for the Tigers. play action. Campbell steps up out of the pocket, runs into his own man, and is about a yard shy of the line of scrimmage. Ronald Fields on the stop, but Jason actually ran into one of his offensive linemen trying to get away.
Just a two-receiver route that time, a little fake to Carnell, the keeper, the tight end, trying to get the ball to Courtney Taylor, but it didn't look like Courtney was looking when Jason had the opportunity to throw it to him in the middle of the field, so Jason just alertly just took the ball, got what he could, about a loss of a yard on the play.
Second down for the Tigers at the state 29. Taylor goes in motion. Carnell Williams stacked up, and he'll lose a couple more yards. Tommy Kelly, defensive end, who has 9 quarterback pressures and has caused 5 or 3 fumbles this season, makes the stop.
Well, Tommy Kelly did a great job that time at Auburn. Stephen Ross just was beaten on that play. He's getting the start because Marcus McNeil has really had a tough time with his back, and he is not going to play in today's ball game. So Auburn with a third down, averaging on percentage-wise about 37% on third downs for the year.
The Tigers are 2 of 3 on third down in this first quarter. A 5-wide set. State rushes 6, and the flag goes down, and Auburn may have run out of time. So instead of 3rd and 13, it will be 3rd and 18 for the Tigers.
Foul is delayed by the offense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot. Repeat of the down.
Auburn's got really 2 ways to look at this. With a short game, Auburn will be in field goal position here. But with a medium game, you might look at this as a 3rd and a 4th down because you're deep. You know, if you get a few yards on this play, you could be under 10 yards to go on 4th down. And if it's a field goal opportunity that looks like it might be too far, Auburn, I don't think Tommy Tuberville would hesitate going for it here.
Auburn needs 18 yards on this 3rd down. Campbell flushed out of the pocket. With some room, if he wants to run, he'll throw to Brandon Johnson, the fullback, who's wrestled down at the 21-yard line. It will be about 2 yards shy of the first down. Odell Bradley, Quentin Culberson, the 2 cornerbacks, made the stop on Johnson, who gets up gingerly for Auburn.
Jason Campbell goes back, gets pressure from his left side, gets around the pressure, does a good job of directing traffic. I thought he might have hit Jarius McIntyre, who popped open in the middle of the field. But let's see if Auburn goes for it on 4th down. That's what we were talking about. If Tommy Tuberville had the opportunity for it, he might go for it on 4th down.
Auburn will have to hustle. The play clock already down to 8. And Jason Campbell, I think wisely so, calls a timeout for Auburn. So 4th down and a yard and a half, maybe 2 yards here for Auburn.
And 4th down, Andy, always adventure, always an adventure with Coach Tuberville. Tommy Tuberville is not afraid, and everybody knows it, to take risks. He's gone for 4th down several times this year. Had the fake punt last week that didn't work against Arkansas, but you can remember a lot of opportunities that Auburn's had on 4th downs. Had, I think, 4 out of 6 on 4th down so far this season. So Auburn doing very well in that category. They got about 2 yards to go. The question is, will they keep it on the ground with only 2 yards to get for the 4th down? And obviously Mississippi State knowing that it's probably going to be a run, or will it be a little play action fake and put Jason Campbell in a run pass situation on the corner?
Tell you what, this situation that was down near the goal line against Tennessee, Auburn ran the play action and then the rollout, and he was able to find Cole Bennett in the end zone for a touchdown.
And this is exactly the situation, whether it was 3rd and 2 here or 4th and 2, that your running game gives you such an advantage, because Auburn has had success in the running game. Everybody knows Auburn likes to get the ball to their tailbacks 30, 40 times a game. So with 4th and 2, you have to protect against the run. And it looks like Auburn has
changed it up.
Now, Andy, the question here is, do you think that this possibly could be a fake field goal attempt?
38-yard field goal for Vaughn. His longest of the season is 34 yards off the left hash mark. Fetzko to hold, Wells to snap. Ball is down, the kick is up, and he missed it wide left. He hooked it. So Auburn comes up empty.
Well, you know, John Vaughn has struggled a little bit, only 4 of 7 on field goals. He's missed a couple of short ones. He seems to be just pushing the ball occasionally, pulling the ball occasionally. He's not as accurate as he is in practice. The game is obviously when you got to make sure that you get the execution on the play. Looked like a pretty good hole by Fesco, and he just pulled it a little bit to the left.
So Auburn comes up empty trying to counter the 77-yard run by Turner. And now in at full or tailback is Fred Reed. He's the third tailback the state's run today, with Bryson Davis as the fullback. Reed stacked up at the line, and he may lose a yard on the play.
Boy, outstanding play by Travis Williams on that one. Andy, he really read that play early, got in there, and actually looks like it might have been a slight loss on the play.
Yeah, Auburn really plugged up the hole, and Williams, tell you what, he's had a lot of plays run his way just trying to want to run away from Dansby and Thomas.
But now Williams stacks up well against these three tailbacks that they have, because he's about a little over 200 pounds and great speed at that linebacker position. So Travis Williams is somebody that Auburn would really like to line up against these tailbacks and go one-on-one, because he's got that kind of mobility and shiftiness that these tailbacks have.
Substitution by the
second
offense.
Time that
penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot, and repeat of the down.
Second time today that State has been flagged for illegal substitution. I think what's happening is they're waiting too long to bring the guy, the 12th man, out of the huddle, Charlie.
Well, you can't break the huddle with 12 men. And there are a lot of reasons for that, but that's been a penalty that has evolved over the years. But with all the substitutions and everything, you have to give your opponent a chance to see who's in the game.
State needs 16 yards on second down. Play action, Fant throws to Davis, and he's taken down by Carlos Dansby. Maybe a yard or maybe two, and that's about all as Dansby makes the open field tackle.
They like to throw the ball to their fullbacks. Of course, Jones with 6 catches coming in. Bryson Davis there with his 3rd reception of the year. But, boy, what a stop by Carlos Dansby. How many times do you see the running back stop, immediately plant, and the linebacker overshoot that tackle? But Carlos Dansby, Auburn's Butkus candidate, didn't do it on that occasion.
State is 0-for-2 on third down today. Needs to get to the 31 for a first. Auburn blitzes, Fant in trouble. Brett Eddins got it back at the 10. Eddins, who had 2 sacks against Tennessee, puts Fant down, and Fant is slow to get up.
Well,
Fant lying on his back right now.
Looks like he's going to be okay, just a little shaken up. Kevin Fant's a tough kid. He's taking a lot of hard licks, and the trainers are out, and they're going to walk him back.
But, watch the pressure by Dansby here, number 11.
Dansby comes on the outside. Pretty good block by Fred Reed, who was really physical on that play. 180 pounds blocking Carlos Dansby at about 235 or 40. But it's Brett Eddins that comes from the inside that gets Kevin Fant.
Trey Smith set to receive this punt. He stands at the 48 of Mississippi State. Robert Wallace averaging 44 yards a punt. Takes this one away. It's a low line drive kick. Trey Smith from the 45. Smith inside the 40 with a flag down, and this is going to come back. Michael Hurd, Robert Spivey on the stop.
Trey Smith, Andy, did a really nice job of reading his blocks. He was patient, waited for the hole, and then he popped right through it, and it's going to be a hold against Auburn. And I tell you, it is almost becoming an unusual thing to see a punt that does not have a penalty involved with it. I mean, if there's a punt return,
holding by the returning team during
Noel
the return, penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul, followed by a first down.
But, you know, Andy, it's almost uncanny to have a punt return that goes for any distance and there not be a hold. It's almost an unusual play.
Auburn has been penalized almost 55 yards a game. State, on the other hand, last in the league, or first, however you look at it, in penalty yardage per game. Back to the 43-yard line. The handoff to Brandon Jacobs. Diving across the 45-yard line. Odell Bradley on the stop. Bradley went low, and Jacobs tried to mow him down, and Bradley got him at the knees.
Boy, another great block here by Auburn's fullback. You see, that's Cooper Wallace, excuse me. It's Cooper Wallace. It's not Brandon Johnson. I thought it was Brandon Johnson, but Cooper Wallace doing a great job of just absolutely shutting down that right side of the defensive line.
Brandon Jacobs stays in at the tailback spot. He got 5 yards on first down. That's Cole Bennett in motion. Short drop, Campbell throws, caught by Obamanu, who then dropped the football, and it's an incomplete pass. Obamanu got drilled by Quentin Culberson. The pass is a little bit high. If he holds on, it's a first down.
That's when Ben Obamanu wants to go back and talk a little bit to Jason Campbell and say, hey, Jason, you got to get that ball down a little bit. Now, Jason threw the ball over the outstretched arms of one of the defenders. That was Marvin Birdsong, who jumped up, the linebacker, tried to knock that pass down. He had to throw it over him, and now third down possession play.
Hand off Brandon Jacobs. He's got the first down, barreling inside the 45-yard line. Slovakia Griffin, gotta love that name, makes the stop, backup strong safety for the Bulldogs.
Gotta wonder what prompted the parents of Slovakia Griffin to call him Slovakia, but be that as it may, great tackle by Slovakia Griffin coming up against a bigger running back. And of course, Brandon Jacobs has got the Auburn crowd very excited every time he gets in the game. They like to see a guy that is that unusual at tailback, 6'4", 250-pound tailback.
First quarter has come to a close. It was an entertaining first quarter. And at the break, Auburn leads Mississippi State 14-7. We're back in a moment right here on CSS in the Auburn Network.
I believe that this is a practical world and that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
I believe in a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women
believe in these things,
I believe in Auburn and love it.
I believe that this is a practice.
A first quarter, Charlie Trotman, that saw two touchdown runs of over 70 yards.
You don't see that very often when Mississippi State and Auburn get together. You know, Coach Dye used to talk about this game, and he always said it was going to be a bloodletting. And that's normally the way it is. And, of course, this Mississippi State team, Andy, a good bit different than the normal Mississippi State team. The normal Mississippi State team runs behind that huge offensive line, and they just pound you and pound you on offense. And then they just play that physical brand of defense, and they just like to beat up on an offensive team. Very aggressive normally, the Jolie Dunn type defense. This year, defense is struggling, and really it's the offense of Mississippi State that's creating things for Jackie Sherrill.
Now, new coordinators this year for State, Ron Cooper in for State on the defense, and Morris Watts on the offense. There's a ton of former head coaches on this staff for Jackie Sherrill. Rocky Felker is administrative or the director of football operations. Curly Hallman is on this staff. First and 10 from the 42, Brandon Jacobs. Down the sideline, out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Odell Bradley, the left cornerback, made the stop on Brandon Jacobs, who is finding room at Tyrone so far.
Little inside trap here. See Manrico Crittenden coming in from that left guard position, going to the right side, leading Brandon Jacobs around. And Brandon Jacobs just gets that speed going. Gets caught barely by Odell Bradley.
Auburn sends Aroma Shadu and Silas Daniels to the top of your screen. From the 22, first down. Here comes the blitz, the pitch to Brandon Jacobs. Fights off one tackle and maybe got a couple yards. Did not really follow his lead blocker, Brandon Johnson, that time. as Clarence McDougal, the Sam linebacker, came up and made the stop for State.
Well, Andy, one thing we can see that's shaping up early in this ball game is Ronnie Brown. We haven't seen play at all for Auburn. And as Brandon Jacobs comes out, Carnell Williams comes back in. But last week, Carnell got really the bulk of almost all the carries, only three carries by Brandon Jacobs. But Auburn has given the ball a little bit more to Brandon Jacobs, sharing the load at tailback.
Second down and 10 for the Tigers. Campbell under center. The handoff to Carnell Williams. Into the secondary and into the end zone. 22 yards on the touchdown. Boy, you just can't give that kind of guy that kind of room in the secondary.
Boy, that was just unbelievable blocking that time. Auburn's Monrico Crittenden and Troy Reddick. They just came off the ball and did a great job. Mark Perra over there. And actually, Carnell Williams was never touched by anybody on that play. He saw daylight off left tackle, broke it back to the right side around the hash mark, and went in around the left, around the right hash mark in the south end zone. Great offensive blocking by Auburn's line.
John Vaughn's extra point makes it a 21-7 lead.
Mississippi State 7 with 14 minutes, 39 seconds left to play.
Carnell Williams goes 22 yards, his second touchdown of the day, and the Tigers are back up by 14.
Don't miss the Auburn Football Review for highlights of today's game. The show features Coach Tuberville's insights as well as in-depth feature looks at this year's Auburn Tigers. Check local listings for the station and time in your area or check page 111 of the Auburn Football Illustrated game program for a complete listing.
Another look as Carnell Williams went 22 yards and the Tiger faithful happy on this sunshiny day.
And Mark Perra and Monrico Crittenden. And actually, let's give credit to Stephen Ross on that block. Auburn's left tackle came down, and Auburn's left guard on that play ended up coming over. That was Monrico Crittenden. And Carnell Williams, look at the day that kid's having. 8 carries for 120 yards and already with 2 touchdowns.
SEC scored a report from Oxford. Ole Miss is putting it to Alabama. The Rebels, they're starting to get a little scary, aren't they? Remember, they come here in a couple weeks. Leading Alabama 41-16 in the fourth. Tigers going 57 yards, just 6 plays in a minute 35.
And these have not been sustained drives that either team has had today. Andy, these are drives that are characterized by big plays.
Yeah,
and
running
drives,
plays.
Yeah, and drives that are characterized by tailback activity. These are tailback reads, great runs by Auburn's tailbacks, Carnell Williams and Brandon Jacobs, and a great run by Mississippi State's tailback Nick Turner to give State their touchdown.
And Turner will just let that one go out of the back of the end zone, and State will have first down and 10 at its own 20-yard line. Philip Yost puts it through the back of the end zone for Auburn.
And Philip Yost, Auburn's distance kicker on placements. If they had a long, long field goal, you've already seen Philip Yost this year have a long kick of 57 yards, yeah, tying Auburn's all-time record. And Neil O'Donohue was the one who had actually done that back in 1975.
Fan back out there for Mississippi State from the 20. A double tight end set. The handoff to Reed, and Travis Williams, who brought the blitz, brought Reed down. Travis Williams is having some kind of day already, Charlie.
Well, the left guard on that play, Will Rogers, wasn't sure what was going to happen. He actually took off and left to go to his left, and this was just going to be a sweep play to the left.
Watching, he uses his foot here for the tackle.
Yeah.
Take a look.
And this is what you call inside out. You're going inside out, plays going to the outside, and you won't let him cut back to the inside. Nice play by Travis Williams.
A loss of 7 on the tackle for loss by Williams. Play action on the fake. Fant in trouble, throws incomplete. Reggie Torpor put the pressure on Kevin Fant, who's not known as a scrambling quarterback, and Fant did a good job of getting out of the pocket, just getting rid of the football.
Reggie Torpor over there on Richard Birch, the left tackle, and he just makes a little inside juke, and Birch kind of lurch is to the to his inside instead of staying to his outside, and Torber does a great job of getting over there. Now Reggie Torber leads Auburn with 7 quarterback hurries. That time will be his 8th. He's got a sack on the year and 2 forced fumbles, so he's having a big year. That's the senior out of Baton Rouge.
Had 5 tackles and a quarterback hurry last week at Arkansas. Fant on the rollout, looking downfield. He throws, it's picked off by Will Herring. Herring stepping in front of the intended pass. First turnover of the day, first career interception for Will Herring.
What a nice read by Will Herring, and a play pass that really shouldn't have been made by a very experienced quarterback. You don't see Kevin Fant throw the ball like this very often, just lobs it up. The ball is wobbling to an intended receiver over there, and that was Bivens. But I tell you what a play by Auburn's Will Herring. Gets over there from that free safety position and cuts right in front of the intended receiver. Sets Auburn up in beautiful position.
Played for Spence McCracken at Opelika High School, did Herring, as Carnell Williams gets a couple yards down to the 35-yard line. Ronald Fields out of Bogalusa, Louisiana, freshman All-SEC a couple years ago, makes the stop.
Now, in Auburn's big win against Mississippi State last year in Starkville, Auburn was the beneficiary of 6 state turnovers. But today, that's the first state turnover, and it gives Auburn a great position deep in Mississippi State territory.
From the 33, second down, the rollout by Campbell. Looks, he throws. Brandon Johnson's got it to the 25-yard line. He'll be about 4 yards shy of the first down. Darren Williams, a strong safety, on the stop for Mississippi State.
Well, Auburn doesn't throw the ball very often to the fullback, and you don't see him catch the ball very often, but he's got very good hands. Brandon Johnson with his first catch on the year, and you saw the defender try to knock the ball out of his hands as he was making the tackle.
Third down. Excuse me, that was good for a first down. I'm sorry, to the 25-yard line. Carnell Williams trying to get to the outside. Uses the stiff arm and gets 9 yards as he's run out of bounds. Kevin Dockery on the business end of the stiff arm there from Carnell Williams.
Carnell, you look at the way that he attacks the defense. He decides whether he's going to go inside or outside. That time just use the speed, get all the way to the end, to the sideline, get as much yardage as you can, and a nice 8-yard gain on the play.
Williams, who is the last 2 weeks SEC Offensive Players of the Week, gets 8 yards on that carry. Carnell Williams is in. Touchdown. 17 yards, and Auburn made it look easy there, didn't it? Third touchdown of the first half for Carnell, going off the left side.
And again, Andy, I don't think that any state defender touched Carnell Williams along that left side again. And again, that's Stephen Ross and Big Monrico Crittenden over there. And Brandon Johnson just absolutely annihilates one of the defenders for Mississippi State. And it was State's number 30 on that play.
Kevin Dockery,
and he helped him up, the strong safety, after the play. A good show of sportsmanship. But Brandon Johnson, how valuable is that guy? We've said it already, but, man, he just makes things happen at that fullback position.
Carnell Williams off the left side. Crittenden and Reddick and Johnson leading the way. And Carnell untouched to the end zone for the touchdown.
Quarterback Carlo Chico's recovery from Reggie Cobb fumble. brought to you by Olshan Foundation Repair. Fix it with Olshan and fix it for good.
The O'Charlie scoring drive by Auburn, 4 plays, 36 yards, including 1 minute 14 seconds, with the touchdown coming on a 17-yard run by Carnell Williams. Auburn has been selected to the second annual Capital One Mascot All-America team.
One big day in the first half. 3 touchdowns for Williams. Now remember this, folks. Carnell had 4 touchdown carries coming into the day. He already has 3 in the first half, Charlie.
And he is just finding the going pretty easy, led by great blocking by the offensive line. Again, Monrico Crittenden, who's moved over to left guard today, and Stephen Ross, who's in for Auburn's Marcus McNeil, who couldn't play today, have just unbelievably handled that left side of the offensive and defensive line. I mean, they are coming off the ball, and nobody has gotten a hand on Carnell on the last 2 touchdown runs. 11 carries, 148 yards. It's actually 3 touchdowns in the first half. And we still have 12 minutes and 33 seconds to go in the second quarter, so really just in a little bit over a quarter.
Will Herring out there on the kickoff coverage. His interception set up the third touchdown or fourth touchdown of the day for Auburn. The third scored by Carnell. Back to the end zone there.
Nice wind behind Philip Yost, but what a strong leg. And I tell you, that's exactly what you need to do with these guys, with Fred Reed and Nick Turner. Don't want to give them the opportunities. Remember last week it was Fred Reed who had a 100-yard touchdown kickoff return against Memphis.
Auburn just needing 4 plays, 36 yards, a minute 14. And I'd forgotten a touchdown by Carnell. He's got 4 touchdowns in the first half, matching the 4 they had coming into the game. From the 20, first down. Fant in the shotgun for Mississippi State. They hand off to Turner, gets to the corner, and then gets wrapped up. Carlos Rogers came up from his quarterback spot to make the stop on Turner.
Wow, what a nice play. It looked like he had a lot of running room. Nick Turner has already got it over a 70-yard touchdown run against the Tigers, and Carlos Rogers comes up and stops him right in his tracks out of Butler High School in Augusta, Georgia, the junior. Coming back, and he had one of the 3 pins removed from his hand this week, and he's back in there for the Tigers.
No gain on first down for State at the 20. It's the screen to Turner. Gets to the sideline. Turner with the first down. He stepped out of bounds. Out of bounds after a gain of... Let's see where they mark him out of bounds here. Turner slow to get up as he was hit downfield. I'm not sure the officials know exactly where he went out of bounds.
Well, they're all, the State coaches are right there. And as you see a shot of Nick Turner right there, who's really slow getting up, he caught a swing pass from Kevin Fant and got through the first wave of Auburn defenders, got to the sideline. Jackie Sherrill is discussing it over there, but not sure exactly where he went out of bounds. Maybe somewhere around the 41-yard line.
Yeah, another look at it from our end zone camera.
Fant looks downfield, draws the defense that way, throws it over to Turner. Turner gets around a couple of Auburn defenders, and they're saying that he went out of bounds there.
Wow, right about, I'm not sure he did, Charlie.
I'm not sure he did either. And, of course, Will Herring did the smart thing, is don't stop, because you never know when that play might have been called and ruled that he was inbounds.
Now that's a break for Auburn, friends. At the 41, first down for Mississippi State. Ball down is, I don't know if that was going to be a reverse. Who's got the ball?
Well, they're trying to see who's got the ball right now. And
State, Turner recovered it.
But it was DeMarco McNeil who was in there about the time the handoff was given. And this was a play that was designed to look like a reverse. And Kevin Fant gets the ball, and he hands it to Nick Turner, but Nick Turner doesn't think he's getting the ball.
I'm not sure Turner thought it was a reverse.
Yeah, Turner.
Or a fake reverse.
Yeah, he thought it was a reverse.
A loss of three on the play back to the 38. Dansby comes on the blitz. Fant in trouble. Dansby got it. Carlos Dansby came on a blitz on a big fourth down play a week ago, taking Matt Jones down late in the Arkansas game. And much as he did there.
And, you know, Carlos Dansby is 235 pounds, and that's just a mismatch when he's trying to go up against Fred Reed, who is 5'9", 180 pounds. And, folks, what he did, he knocked Reed all the way into the quarterback.
Yeah, he did.
Wow. What a charge by Carlos Dansby.
Dansby in the semifinal list for the Butkus Award. That was announced this week. We see why. Third and 20. Fant throws deep. Incomplete. Junior Rosebreen with pretty good coverage that time downfield for Auburn.
And it was McKinley Scott, a speedster out of Tunica, Mississippi, that he had great coverage on, just would not let it get behind him. And again, we talked at the first of the show about Junior Rosebreen and how valuable is that guy when Junior Rosebreen can play both cornerback and safety. He's got that kind of athletic ability.
Robert Wallace on to punt it again for Mississippi State. Short off the side of his foot. Auburn bounce out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
A little bit unusual for Mississippi State because they normally are very sound in the kicking game, have great punters, great kickers. That's been sort of a hallmark of Jackie Sherrill teams, but a shank that time by the punter and sets Auburn up again in good field position. And Jason Campbell still in the game. Auburn's going to come in this series, Andy, with Brandon Jacobs instead of Carnell starting the series.
Jackie Sherrill announcing his retirement yesterday. And his ball club down by 21 with 10:01 to go in the first half. Courtney Taylor, the man in motion. Brandon Jacobs on the carry. Bounces to the outside, tries to take his hat off. Jacobs gets a couple more yards with a late flag in, and we may see a face mask here.
Well, it came in late. Brandon Jacobs kept fighting, all types of state defenders on his back. Got about 5 yards, almost six on the play, and looks like they're going to get maybe an incidental face mask.
5 yard face mask penalty, that's exactly right. By the way, in case you're wondering, and we looked this up right now because Carnell, although he's not out there right now, has 4 touchdowns in the first half. The Auburn record for touchdown runs in a game, Joe Cribbs with 5 against Vanderbilt. Charlie, do you remember this game?
Yours truly was handing the ball off to him, and Auburn was in good shape because I didn't have to pass the ball.
That was back in, it was October 14th in 1978.
Yeah, I remember that game. Tearaway jerseys. Well, Joe Cribbs used
the 5-yard face mask.
And there's the call
by the defense.
Dual Jackson, the referee.
Is 5 yards from the end of the run and still first down.
Today it would be called a disposable jersey.
Yeah. Yeah, and I tell you, it was interesting because at that time you could wear the jerseys that just would tear away and they'd stick another one on you just as easily as if you were putting your own T-shirt on. But that's illegal now because if you use a jersey that tears off, you have to come out for a play.
Jacobs remains in at tailback right now with Wallace in motion. First and 1 for Auburn. Jacobs down to the 44-yard line. And a flag goes down.
The flag came in late. The umpire actually made the call, and it's going to be a hold against Auburn.
Yeah, this one's coming back. McDougal and Lenny Day combined on the stop for State.
You know, Brandon Jacobs is tall, and he's a 6'4 tailback.
Foul was holding by the offense. Penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul with a repeat of the first down.
And actually, Andy, on the end of this play, when he decides that he's not going to get any more yardage, he actually just falls forward, even laying down, and gets an extra couple of yards. You know, he's really a special player.
Yes, he is. At 6'4", 257 from Napoleonville, Louisiana. Cooper Wallace in motion. Jacobs is going to get the carry again. Cuts it upfield. Jacobs down to the 41. Odell Bradley, a pretty nice tackle on Brandon Jacobs against the first down. Brandon Jacobs is having some kind of day.
Well, Odell Bradley had the nice tackle, but it was number 22. It was Darren Williams that took the brunt of this lick. Watch this. Ooh, Darren Williams comes in there and thinks he's going to really get a shot on Brandon Jacobs, and he ends up going backwards and turns sideways himself. And Brandon Jacobs took a hard lick, shows his durability on that play.
First and 10 from the 42. Jacobs again. Feet taken out from underneath him as he gets inside the 40. Bradley again making the stop for Mississippi State.
You know, Odell Bradley is a very good player. Two interceptions coming in, left cornerback, second leading tackler on the team. But the one thing about that is if your cornerback, Odell Bradley, is your second leading tackler, and your free safety, Kevin Dockery, is your third leading tackler, then something's not happening for your defense.
Second down and six for Auburn. The handoff again to Jacobs. Brandon down to the 35-yard line.
And Mississippi State's defense has not given up any big play in this drive. They're making Auburn earn every inch they're getting.
Day and Birdsong combined on the stop. You saw Ben Grubbs in there at the tight end for Auburn. Actually, Auburn's third tight end today was Stephen Ross moving from tight end to tackle. Number 84, Grubbs. See him setting up in the slot and now in motion. Again, Jacobs right up the middle. Brandon Jacobs down to the 20-yard line and a first down for Auburn. He got 15 on the play. Darren Williams makes the stop. And Brandon Jacobs is getting close to the 100-yard mark here in the first half.
So close. This is one of those shoestring tackles. Watch Brandon Jacobs finding some great blocking. And then, again, the tackle was made by number 22, Darren Williams, who seems to be making a lot of contact with Brandon Jacobs on this drive. Good tackle by the strong safety.
Well, look, 85 yards in the first half for Jacobs. Auburn could have two 100-yard rushers in the first half. Jacobs through traffic. Jacobs down to the 15-yard line. Ronald Fields had a career best 9 tackles and a sack at Houston earlier this season, makes the stop for State.
Yeah, Ronald Fields just rode for a while, about 5 yards on that particular play. Brandon Jacobs just carried a guy that weighs 300 pounds for about 5 yards on that play. Nice tackle by Fields, but he thought he was going to get him down a little bit before he did.
Well, Jacobs comes out and Carnell is in with Jake Slaughter at fullback for Auburn. Williams down to the 10. Carnell got 4 yards on the play, maybe 5. T.J. Mulwinney and Darren Williams on the stop, and we haven't heard much from Mulwinney here in the first half, Charlie.
Well, we really hadn't, and T.J. Mulwinney is their leading tackler. He's the senior leader on that defense. He's from Madisonville, Louisiana, out of Charleston Southern High School. Great player. Came and has started and played great defense for several years for Jackie Sherrill.
Timeout call with 6 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the first half of play. Tigers up by a score of 28-7.
Now taking the lead of the Red Tigers to the scoreboard. Final score, Miami over Temple, 52-14. In the third quarter,
6:18 to go in the first half. Auburn on top of Mississippi State, 28-7. First and 10 for Auburn at the 10-yard line. And Carnell Williams in a tailback for the Tigers right now. Charlie, he could tie the Auburn single game record for touchdowns here in this first half.
And the really intriguing thing about that is the team that he's doing it against. I mean, Joe Cribbs, when we played in 78 in that game, Joe Cribbs had those 5 touchdowns against Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt didn't have a great football team, but Mississippi State normally defensively, if you get over 100 yards rushing against Mississippi State, you've had a phenomenal game. And he's got over 100 yards rushing in the first half. And Brandon Jacobs is at 89 yards on 11 carries. 12 carries for Carnell, 153 yards and four touchdowns at this point in the game with a little over 6 minutes to go in the second quarter.
All right, Jacobs is back in at tailback for Auburn on first down and 10 from the 10. Campbell to Brandon Jacobs to the line of scrimmage and then pushed back. Jacobs did a good job just to get to the line. Tommy Kelly, who only played 1 year of high school football out of Hines Community College then and originally out of Jackson, Tennessee, made the stop for state.
But he leads their team in tackles behind the line of scrimmage with six. And Tommy Kelly at 6'6", 303 pounds. You're talking about a huge defensive end.
Second and 11. Jacobs finds the hole, gets inside the 10, down to about the 7. Dockery and Fields for State on the tackle.
Well, you had the feeling that Brandon Jacobs was just about to break out of those tackles, a grasp of a couple of players, and this is just a stretch play over to the right side. Auburn gets a hat on everybody, and Brandon Jacobs comes in there, a nice initial hit in there by McDougal, Clarence McDougal, and it's going to set Auburn up on with a third down.
Anthony Mix and Ben Obamano to the top of your screen. McIntyre to the bottom, third and goal from the 7. Jacobs hit behind the line. Brandon Jacobs carrying players down to the 1. He could have been hit for no loss on the play.
Well, the question is, did he get a first down? Because he come very, it's going to be very close to a first down. I don't know if he got it or not.
Got some help from Monrico Crittenden at the end of that play.
They're saying he did get the first down.
Well, on the other side, it still says fourth down on the marker.
Well, now they are saying
yeah.
Fourth down.
Fourth down.
Fourth down.
At the 1. Campbell with Brandon Jacobs in motion to Carnell. Flag down. Did he get in? Yes, he did, but hold the phones. Hold the phones. A pair of flags down on the play. Two flags in the end zone thrown down. It's against State, and Carnell Williams has his 5th touchdown of the day.
Andy, I think it was illegal participation. I think there were 12 men on the field. Not sure, but the penalty nonetheless is going to be declined, and Auburn is going to have another Carnell Williams touchdown.
4:05 to go in the first half as Williams gets his 5th touchdown of the half. Philip Yost on for his 2nd extra point attempt. Good the last time. And it is on the way, and it is good. The Tigers, who haven't missed a point after attempt in quite some time, add another as Carnell Williams goes for his 5th touchdown of the day.
Led in there by Jake Slaughter. Jake Slaughter pushing that pile back. Carnell trying to get in there. He only had about a yard to go, a little less than a yard. And Brandon Jacobs is in there also. Made a nice block in there on one of the linebackers for Mississippi State. And Carnell gets his 5th touchdown. That's history right there, folks. Joe Cribbs with 5 touchdowns in 4 quarters. Carnell with 5 touchdowns in 2 quarters.
Tying the record set by Cribbs back in Charlie's day, 1978.
You kind of said that like it was a prehistoric era or something like that, Andy.
Well, there were tearaway jerseys.
And yeah, but we did have face masks. We did have face masks.
Glad to hear it.
Yeah. We had shoulder pads. Nobody wore flak jackets, though. You know how the running backs all wear the rib protectors?
You didn't Nobody. Get any at the quarterback didn't get one then?
Quarterback didn't have any rib protectors. Nobody. They were not invented at that time. And I tell you
well,
what,
that
they would have been a very I would have loved
that. Explains a whole lot then, friends.
Well, you know, the running backs at that era, when they got hit in the ribs, they had to get up and just play with the broken ribs. But the rib protectors are probably the best innovation of football equipment, I mean, seriously, in the last 15 years.
A look at the scoring drive. Auburn almost 6 minutes on the drive, 58 yards and 11 plays.
Now remember, the last two scores that Auburn has had came one off a Kevin Fant interception by Will Hearing, and secondly, off a shank of the punt in great field position for the Auburn offense.
Out of the back of the end zone, Turner with no opportunity to return that one. You know, as you see Yost come off the field, Carnell Williams, the last 2 weeks has been the SEC Offensive Player of the Week. I mean, someone's going to have to go a long way to make sure that Carnell doesn't win it for the third straight week, Charlie.
Well, the only way that I see that he might not win it is if they don't play him in the second half, because right now, this Mississippi State defense is just not getting to the point of attack. I mean, Auburn's getting hats on everybody. The Auburn offensive line's doing a terrific job. Auburn has rushed the ball almost at will here in the first half.
From the 20, first down for Mississippi State, the handoff to Turner. Stood up by DeMarco McNeil. He was the first one there for Auburn.
And this ought to be a game. You see all of Auburn starters still out there right now. But this ought to be a game in the second half with a lead 35-7. Only 3:41 to go in the second quarter, that Auburn can get a lot of people in the ball game defensively and offensively and create a lot of depth, get a lot of people who don't normally get playing time against SEC competition.
Auburn up 35-7. The blitz comes and the fullback Jones goes down on the screen. Reggie Torbor led the charge for Auburn.
That was excellent defense, and I'll tell you why. Kevin Fant did a great job here. This is a fake of the screen to the right and then a screen pass to the left. What Auburn's defensive players did is they read the offensive line and they followed him over to the running back who got the ball on that play, the fullback Jones.
A loss of four. It's third and 11 for Mississippi State. From the gun, Fan steps up into the pocket, throwing it deep, and a flag will be thrown. Karabididi collided on the play with Justin Jenkins. Jenkins, the leading receiver in the SEC coming into play today. Well, and I wonder if that's a catchable ball there, Charlie.
Yeah, I think the pass was thrown so it wasn't catchable, but they're going to get Auburn for interference. But actually, Karabididi was trying to turn and get the ball. It looked like that Fant was trying to get the ball to Jenkins, but Didi was in a position that he really couldn't get out of the way.
I don't think Jenkins comes close to catching the football here, Charlie, if he's not collided with it. Tommy Tuberville is a little upset. Another look.
Jenkins is going to come on your left side of the screen. He gets shucked at the line of scrimmage by Carlos Rogers, and actually, on that angle, it does not look like a bad call. It does look like a proper call at that angle, because Jenkins was running back on a corner route, and Didi came up and just impeded his motion.
The handoff to Turner, taken down in the backfield. Carlos Dansby on the stop.
Going back to that call, and you know, officiating has been a big factor this year in college football, because obviously you saw against Arkansas, Houston Nutt upset about the officials and a couple of plays, and Bobby Gaston, the head of SEC officials, ruling that they were proper calls. But on review, that looked like a proper call. The question was whether the ball was so far overthrown, if it was catchable or not.
Second and 13 for the Bulldogs. Fant loads it up and throws. Incomplete. Diving play by Dontarius Thomas to make sure that Jenkins didn't catch the ball.
Nice read by Dontarius Thomas. That's been really the soft spot of the Auburn defense as far as pass defense is concerned, between the hash marks. That's where Casey Clawson found a lot of throwing room, and Auburn was hurt several times. But look at the reaction of Dontarius Thomas coming in there and diving for the ball. It was intended again for Jenkins. Auburn has completely taken Jenkins out of the ball game, averaging over six catches a game and nearly 100 yards in receptions.
And a timeout called by Mississippi State. Charlie, you can go on with that. I mean, this was a guy that was far and away the leading receiver in the SEC coming into play today.
Yeah, averaging over 15 yards reception and averaging over six catches per ball game.
And seven touchdowns for a receiver, are you kidding?
Yeah, and a long play of 70 yards. And if you saw 7 points up, you would think that Kevin Fant had probably found Jenkins somewhere in this ball game. But instead, it was Nick Turner on a 70-plus yard run for the touchdown, the lone score that the Bulldogs have. And Auburn right now enjoying a 35-7 lead with great rushing of the football by the Auburn Tigers in the first half.
To show you the kind of season that Jenkins has had, that 7 touchdowns is one behind the Mississippi State school record of 8 that he set last year. He's already just one behind his school record midway through the season, and Auburn has shut him out here in the first half thus far.
Yeah, and he's had big games, Andy. You're talking about a great receiver in Eric Moles that caught 10 passes against Auburn back a few years ago. He's been a great player for the Buffalo Bills, but Justin Jenkins is really doing everything that Eric Moles ever thought about doing. He's had, 9 catches in a ball game recently. He's had great games against some of the really good defenders. And look at this. 3 completions out of 10 attempts for 7 yards with an interception. And how many people would have felt that at almost halftime, Kevin Fant would have only thrown 10 passes?
3rd and 13 for the Bulldogs. Fant steps up, rolling, throwing, and complete. Nice catch on the play by Omar Connor. And Connor down inside the 40 to the 36. Well, that's a nice play by both Kevin Fant and Omar Connor.
Now, for all you young players out there that are watching, this is what happens when a receiver comes back to the football. Auburn's Kevin Hobbs thinks he has an interception there. He is waiting for the ball and is going to get an interception, but Omar Connor comes back to the quarterback, makes a great play.
And you saw him cover that ball up as he was about to be tackled from the 36, first down. Fant in trouble. Torborg got him. He throws it away. A little shovel pass to Nick Turner.
And Auburn's doing a good job of pressuring Kevin Fant.
Reggie Torborg is abusing Richard Birch out here on the tackle spot.
Yeah, Richard Birch at 6'5", 320, certainly has the size advantage on Reggie Torborg. But right now, Reggie Torborg is just out-quicking him around the corner.
Fant floats it to Turner, in some trouble. Down he goes. Very good pursuit that time. Torborg with Spencer Johnson bearing down on Turner.
Now, if we get a look at this, Andy, you'll see Reggie Torborg make an outside move, and it gets that left tackle, Birch, to go to his outside. Then he goes back to his inside and then goes all the way across the center's face to the other side of the field. Watch this on the left tackle right there. A little fake to the outside. Birch goes to the outside. You can't quite see it, but Reggie Torborg will make this tackle. Number 82 coming into the picture right now. Yeah. What a play.
Jay Ratliff put pressure on Fant. Good to see Jay out there after twisting his ankle at Georgia Tech. Fant with time, throws, complete. And then a fumble. Ball is loose. Still loose. I think Auburn got it. Let's see. Yep, Tigers ball. Justin Jenkins, his first catch of the day, and then he coughs it up.
Now, that's the Kevin Fant that everybody expected to see today at Auburn. Now, Kevin Fant just takes this ball out of the shotgun. He steps up and fires a missile. This is a beautiful pass to Jenkins. Jenkins in there, and the ball, he just tries to throw his arm up around Karibi Didi, and the ball flies out of his hands, just trying to make something out of a trying to get away from that tackle. Auburn star, free safety, Karibi Didi.
Two turnovers by State today, both recovered by Opelika High School players. Will Herring and then T.J. Jackson got the fumble recovery there. The throw complete to Ben Obamanu, spinning to the 40-yard line and a first down for Auburn. They get about 14 on the play. Mawinney and Bradley on the stop against Selma High School's Ben Obamanu, who stumbles off the field for Auburn.
Auburn has 2 timeouts remaining, 43 seconds to go in the first half, and Auburn on their own 40-yard line with 2 timeouts remaining, a first down, and they're going to run the 2-minute drill.
Out of the shotgun, Campbell. With time, throws. It's a drag route. Or the slip screen to Jairus McIntyre. Boy, does he make people miss. Flag down, McIntyre to the 35. McIntyre down to the 30, but let's see where the flag goes.
Boy, this was such an unbelievable individual effort. It's going to be a shame if it's brought back. It won't be brought back all the way, but it's probably going to be brought back from the point of it's probably going to be a block or a hold on Auburn.
I think this
go the other way. Yeah, Jairus McIntyre is going to get the total yardage on this play. And boy, this is nothing more than a slip screen to the left. Ball thrown nicely by Jason Campbell. Good block by Manrico Crittenden. Troy Reddick in there doing a good job. And look at Jairus McIntyre. And I said he's like a tailback after he catches the ball. And Auburn finds good thing after good thing happening for the offense when they get it to number 81.
McIntyre with the first down to the 27 of Mississippi State. Out of the gun, Campbell. Now flushed. He's going to try and run with it. Campbell's going to get a couple before he wisely gets out of bounds with 9 seconds to go in the first half.
Well, now, there's a question right now because with only 9 seconds to go in the half, you know, normally a play, Andy, takes about 6 to 7 seconds.
Auburn does have two timeouts left.
Auburn's got a timeout left, but you may end up losing an opportunity at a field goal if the ball's caught in bounds and you don't get the timeout quick enough. So I think Auburn's going to wisely go ahead and try the field goal here.
So it'll be a 42-yard attempt as Yost is out. Wells to snap it. Fetzko to hold it. 42 yards from the left hash mark for Philip Yost. In the air. Right down the middle for Yost. And the first half comes to a close. All zeros on the clock. And Auburn on a 42-yard field goal by Yost takes a 38-7 lead into the locker room. Well, so far, Charlie, no signs of letdown by Auburn.
Was such a big game against Arkansas. It certainly was an opportunity for Auburn to look at this game and not get up for it, but you can't say that. Auburn has done a great job in the first half.
Campbell under center, took the throw. Fires, caught at the 25. Still on his feet, McIntyre to the 20, to the 15, to the 10, 5, gone! Touchdown, Auburn!
The 2003-2004 season begins a new chapter in the Auburn Athletics history books as Rod Bramlett enters his first year as the play-by-play announcer for the Auburn Tigers.
Having gone to Auburn, graduated from Auburn, being in broadcasting, like I've said many, many times, I mean, it's a dream come true. I mean, this is a dream job. I can't imagine if folks like the job I'm doing, then I foresee myself doing this for a long, long time.
Starting a new job is one thing, following an Auburn legend in your new career is another.
I don't think that anyone, whether it would be me or whoever, if they went in thinking they were going to fill Jim's shoes, would be very successful, because there was only one Jim Fite, and I think it's important for everyone to remember that. And I think people do realize that. That's the one thing that has stood out the most to me in the responses that I've received from fans telling me to be myself, that don't try to copy Jim. And I think that's great advice. And I think the fans realize there'll never be another Jim Fife. And they are shoes that can't be filled. But I'm certainly honored and humbled by the fact that I was chosen to follow up Jim's legacy.
Bramlett has been in the radio industry since his sophomore year in college and has been the announcer for Auburn baseball since 1993. This experience has helped Bramlett transition into his new role.
I think my experience doing baseball and basketball will help in the sense that I know what's expected. Having done basketball and been around Jim, having been around Jim during football games, I now know what's expected of me.
In the backfield along with Brandon Johnson. Brandon Jacobs in motion. And the give is to Smith. Up, over, and in! Touchdown, Auburn! 10:06 to go in the first quarter. Trey Smith up and over for the first score of the game.
Along with his daily responsibilities as the director of broadcast services for the Auburn Network, Bramlett now sets aside preparation time for his football broadcasts.
Typical preparation is basically just sitting down and and with the game notes going through, the game notes that come out each week, and going through the rosters and putting together spotting boards and charts of that nature. In terms of actual preparation time, I'll probably spend particularly the week or two leading up to the game, probably at least 3 or 4 hours each day, just doing little things like that. And it's the repetition, I think, that really helps you get prepared. You do the same types of things over and over. You read the notes over and over. It's kind of like studying for a test. It's doing your homework and getting ready for that big test.
Of the many changes occurring in Bramlett's career, he also has an addition to his family life. Bramlett is now the proud father of a baby boy. Joshua Baird Bramlett was born Wednesday, October 1st at 6:15 in the evening, weighing 8 pounds, 14 ounces. Joshua is Bramlett and wife Paula's second child. They also have a daughter, Shelby. Even though Auburn fans are hearing a different voice for the first time since 1981, the voice they are hearing is familiar and that of a true Auburn man.
That this is a practical world and that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
I believe in a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women believe in these things, I believe in Auburn and love it.
Carnell Cadillac Williams, Auburn's 5'11", 202-pound smooth ride of a running back, has been running in overdrive all his life. The junior from Atala did nothing to distract attention from himself as a four-year starter at Etowah High School after amassing over 6,000 career yards and leading Etowah to a Class 5A state championship his junior year. Carnell found himself in the middle of a heated recruiting battle following his senior season.
I mean, it was a long, stressful process because you know, he had a lot of teams from across the country coming on my house, you know, every night calling, things like that. But, you know, when everything came down to it, when Coach Tubb, you know, his staff came down, I mean, they were just straight up with me. And I felt more, you know, at home down here than I did other places. So that's basically why I, you know, chose on.
After signing with the Tigers, the former Mr. Football in the state of Alabama hit the ground running. Cadillac made the adjustment to the college game with ease, as was evident in his freshman campaign against Georgia. If one doubted his durability, Carnell left all the doubt on the field at Sanford Stadium that autumn afternoon. The true freshman rushed for a school single game record 41 times, while gaining 167 yards and 2 touchdowns. The following week, Carnell was once again ready to prove himself in the biggest game of his young career versus Alabama. After starting strong, misfortune struck the fabulous freshman on his fifth carry.
That was tough because, you know, my whole life, you know, being from Alabama, you know about that game. So it was finally here. I was finally playing in it. Then, you know, I got off to a pretty good start. And then when I went down, that injury just crushed me. But, you know, that offseason, I just worked very hard to, you know, get back up to that game, you know, but it didn't happen.
Cadillac started the 2002 season with no signs of injury lag and looked impressive in the opener versus USC. 9 touchdowns and 651 yards later, the electric sophomore found himself atop the SEC in rushing. But once again, fate was not his friend. On October 19th at Florida Field, his season was once more cut short by injury.
I mean, you know, of course, when things happen like that, I kind of got down at times, you know, started feeling sorry for myself, asking, you know, why it got happened to me once I get going. But I know, you know, the Lord do everything for a reason. So I just put my faith in him, you know, and just continue to press on.
Coming into 2003, Auburn's talent level in the backfield was as impressive as ever. With the addition of JUCO All-American Brandon Jacobs, coupled with 1,000-yard rusher Ronnie Brown, and the emergence of Trey Smith, Cadillac knew he could not take his first team role lightly.
He was on magazines and, you know, New York Times, you know, the Four Horsemen, things like that. So we knew coming the season that, you know, a lot of eyes were going to be on us. But, you know, we don't put that added pressure on ourselves. Like, we have to feel like we got to do this or do that.
And taking it lightly, he has not, as the junior has returned Auburn's leading stallion out of the backfield, rushing for 402 yards and 3 touchdowns. Once more, Auburn's Cadillac
is running in overdrive.
I believe that this is a practical world.
And that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work, hard work.
I believe in education.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
I believe in a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women
believe in these things,
I believe in Auburn and love it.
Auburn's great mascot, Aubrey, never utters a sound, but his actions speak much louder than words.
Meet Aubrey, Auburn University's Goodwill Ambassador and five-time Mascot of the Year national champion. Aubrey was born more than 60 years ago through the creative drawings of a Birmingham Post-Herald artist.
Phil Neal is the gentleman who created the cartoon character of Aubrey in 1959. And that character graced the cover of all our football programs in those days. And in 1979, the SGA Director of Spirit, a student named James Lloyd, who now lives in Anniston, came up with the idea of bringing the mascot to life.
From the pages of football programs to a lovable and charming mascot, Aubrey has captured the true Auburn spirit and the hearts of thousands of fans.
Aubrey to the Auburn family means the spirit of Auburn. Whenever we're at a football game, no matter if we're winning or losing, Aubrey still maintains that winning attitude. His spirit's always there. He never loses character.
It takes a special individual to embody the Auburn spirit on a full-time basis. Choosing this individual is a complex process.
We have selections every spring. And at Auburn, we have a lot of students that show interest. We'll have about 40 that show up at an orientation meeting in January and February. When it comes down to the clinic, we have a week of clinic every night where students get to get in the suit and learn how to walk like Aubrey and learn what it's like to plan skits. By the end of that week, we're usually left with an average of 16 to 20 students. The tryouts consist of a skit that each person will perform in the suit. And then the second day of tryouts is called impromptus, and that's when each candidate comes out in the costume and they react to music and to props, and they've had no chance to prepare, nor have they heard the music that's playing to see how spontaneous they are.
Aubrey has come a long way since his first appearance over two decades ago. From just a drawing on a piece of paper, he has developed into the mascot that Auburn fans know and love at every Auburn athletic event. And today, there's more involved than sideline antics and playful pranks on game days.
There's so many activities during the week. There's at least, I'd say, six or seven appearances before a football game. It's just a lot more than what it looks like, and it's so hard just to, for someone who's not in the situation, just to fathom how much work goes into it. But it's a full-time job plus school.
With numerous public appearances and charity events, those involved with Aubrey will surely cherish the countless memories.
I was with Aubrey one time, and he was at Camp Aska, and cheerleaders went, Aubrey was there. It was for the camp that week was with kids with sickle cell anemia, and you know, all the kids weren't feeling good. They were sick of taking meds, and they were having a dance that night, and there was one kid that was having a hard time eating his food that night. I was bursting in tears and just was not feeling good. So Aubrey came out and spent some special time just with him before. And as soon as he saw Aubrey, a smile came to his face.
From a cartoon character in 1959 to a national champion in 2003, Aubrey is and will always be an integral part of Auburn tradition.
Be sure to vote for Aubrey for the 2003 National Mascot of the Year. You can vote once a day at CapitalOneBowl.com.
I believe that this is a practical world.
And that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe in education.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
And a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women believe in these things.
I believe in Auburn and love it.
Georgia 10, Vanderbilt 2. In the second quarter, Southern California 28, Notre Dame 14. In the first quarter, Ohio State leads Iowa 10-0. In the first quarter, no score between Florida and Arkansas. Final score, Michigan State 44, Minnesota 38. Final score, Nebraska 48, Texas A&M 12. Final score, Ole Miss 43, Alabama 28.
38-7, Auburn on top at the half against Mississippi State on a sunny day on the plains at Jordan-Hare Stadium with former Auburn quarterback Charlie Trotman. I'm Andy Burcham. Charlie, I know that there was some thought that perhaps this would be a letdown game for Auburn. Two emotional wins over Tennessee and Arkansas, LSU on the road next week, the announced retirement of Jackie Sherrill, but we saw no evidence of a letdown in the first half.
Boy, you really didn't. 38 first half points by Auburn, Andy. That's the most points that Auburn's had in the first half since 1990 against Vanderbilt. Five touchdowns in the first half by Cornell Williams. A dominant rushing game. Right now, Auburn with 280 yards rushing in the first half, 410 yards of offense in the first half. It's only 136. For Mississippi State. Right now, Auburn has done everything right in the first half.
Take a look at the first half statistics. So we saw two 70-yard touchdown runs, one by Auburn, the first here by Carnell Williams as he goes 72 yards. Good downfield blocking by Devin Aroma-Shadu and little talent from number 24 as well. He gets the first of a school record five touchdowns in the first half of play. Again, Williams following his blocking for the second score, just getting across the goal line. Now, State cut the lead in half as Turner goes 77 yards.
Yeah, watch this run by Nick Turner. The sophomore makes a great move there on Auburn's Karibi Didi, and then he just outruns Kevin Hobbs, who almost catches him about the 10-yard line, but he gets on in for over a 70-yard touchdown for Mississippi State. Cuts it to 14-7.
Auburn comes right back as Carnell is untouched on a 22-yard scamper. And then we see Carnell again for his third of five touchdowns in the first half of play. Again, just great blocking as he goes 15 yards for that touchdown. And we look at the first half statistics, and it really tells the story, Charlie.
Boy, look at the yards rushing. That's where the game has been made for Auburn. 286 yards for Auburn with Carnell Williams and Brandon Jacobs doing the bulk of the carries. Five touchdowns for Carnell. And Kevin Fant, really not a factor. Justin Jenkins, a great receiver, was held in check. And you're talking about an offense that's averaging almost 400 yards a game for Mississippi State, and they were held to 136 yards in the first half. Auburn's defense played well, other than the one run by Nick Turner, and yeah, it's been a magical first half for the Tigers.
Auburn's offensive numbers are numbers you normally see at the end of the game, not at halftime. The Tigers on top, 38-7. Second half coming up on CSS and the Auburn Network.
I believe that this is a practical world.
And that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe in education.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
And a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women believe in these things.
I believe in Auburn and love it.
Enter the second half of play. One final already in SEC action. Ole Miss over Alabama, 43-28 in Oxford. They're in the third quarter now in Nashville with Georgia leading Vandy 10-2. No score between Florida and Arkansas in the first. Yost again. This time Turner 8 yards deep into the end zone. And Auburn has taken away one of the top weapons at Mississippi State, Charlie, and that's the return game with good kickoffs from Yost.
Well, you don't want to give the ball to Nick Turner or Fred Reed in the open field. Jarius Norwood, the starting tailback, was injured really his first or second carry of the game, and we have not seen number 12 back at tailback. It's been all Nick Turner and all Fred Reed, and we have not seen, and hopefully Jarius Norwood was not seriously injured.
Turner is in there now at tailback for Mississippi State, first and 10 from the 20. Ray Bivens in motion. Turner taken down. He'll lose a couple yards on the play. Dontarius Thomas, who a week ago showed some wheels running down Reggie Cobbs, Cedric Cobbs of Arkansas in Fayetteville, that time plugging the gap in the middle.
Yeah, Dontarius Thomas, second leading tackler coming into the game, had 39 tackles. He's also tied for second on Auburn with 4 tackles for loss. So, and that's his fifth. That was a great reaction there by Dontarius Thomas.
Second down and 12 for State. Fant rolls, and he's got some room to run. Kevin Fant to the 26-yard line. Taken down in the open field by Junior Rosegreen. Third down facing Mississippi State here.
Reggie Torbore was pressuring Fant. Fant ran upfield, got around Auburn's number 82, as you saw right there. And then Fant has a good foot speed to get to the outside. Made a nice play on that to give a third down and short for Mississippi State.
State needs 3 yards on this third down play from the 27. Fant
Have to step away from Torborg. He got it at the 25. Torborg gets his second sack of the day.
Boy, Reggie Torborg has been a terror in the face of Kevin Fant all day long. They just cannot block him. Birch, again, just doesn't have the foot speed to get outside, and the quickness of Reggie Torborg just gets around the big left tackle. And your left tackle is normally your best pass blocker. And Big Birch, Richard Birch, at 320 pounds, having a hard time with the foot speed of Torborg.
A bomb of a punt by Wallace sends Trey Smith to the 15. And he's still alive. Got a great block. Trey Smith all the way inside Mississippi State territory. Whoa, man, what a return by number 22, Jared Cook, on the touchdown saving tackle.
Well, that's one situation where your punter may have over kicked or out kicked the coverage, but Trey Smith was caught early in this. And one of the defenders just has a great shot at him right there to make the tackle, and he just pirouettes out of it and then catches some blocks going to the right side. And one of the Mississippi State defenders is still down on the field, but Auburn gets the ball for their first possession of the second half in Mississippi State territory at the 47.
Charlie, that's the player that got absolutely drilled on the block. Tigers with their first possession coming up, leading 38-7.
Auburn about to send the offense on the field for the first time here in the second half, following a 37-yard return by Trey Smith. Adrian Griffin gets drilled right here. Whew. That is a vicious block that sprung Trey Smith on a 37-yard return.
Andy, that's reminiscent of most of Auburn Mississippi State games, because these games are so physical. We mentioned historically the coaches would often get you ready and mentally prepared to really get into a war. I mean, you talk about these SEC wars, and Auburn Mississippi State has always been one of them, and very physical out on the playing field.
Jason Campbell in the first team offense out there. We see Trey Smith actually line up in what would be the fullback spot, with Brandon Jacobs lined up at tailback. Auburn from the Mississippi State 47-yard line. Hand off, Brandon Jacobs. Jacobs taken down at the 45-yard line. Darren Williams. That's one of the only ways you can bring down big number 27, slicing at the knees.
Brandon Jacobs with 98 yards on 14 carries, averaging 7 yards a carry in the first half. And you're talking about a flip-flop now with Brandon Jacobs at tailback, and then you're looking at Trey Smith at fullback. Normally you'd see that reversed, but Trey Smith, very versatile. Look for the inside counterplay here.
Jacobs in motion. Smith is in the slot. And Campbell to throw. He didn't run out of time, but there may have been movement. It may have been the center, Danny Lindsay, that.
Moving the ball prior to the snap for the offense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot with a repeat of the second down.
As you can see, Danny Lindsay thought that it was going to be maybe on the first down, and ended up being on the second count. And that time, Danny Lindsay just didn't quite stop the ball, and you can't do that as a center. And 5-yard penalty for Auburn.
Six penalties against the Tigers for 50 yards. Campbell floats it to Trey Smith. A move to get back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's about all. Darren Williams and Marvin Birdsong on the stop.
By Darren Williams.
You know, Trey Smith has got a lot of versatility to his game, and the Auburn coaches like to try to get to the ball to Trey in a lot of different formations. They've run a counterplay, an inside counterplay. Now they've got him as the sole setback, and we'll see what Auburn does here on a possession play.
Third and 11 for Auburn. Campbell to Trey Smith. Gets about to the line, maybe a yard, and that's about all. Wonder how much, if at all, we will see Carnell Williams today. Ronald Fields on the stop as we see Trey Smith on that flare, and I wonder how much more we'll see out of Jason Campbell here in this ball game.
Well, good first series of the second half for the Mississippi State defense. Auburn with 38 first half points, and Mississippi State defensively obviously trying to make some adjustments at halftime, come back and play a little bit better in the second half.
Cody Bliss to punt this one away. Turner stands at the 10. Bliss sends this one high into the air. Taking an Auburn bounce down to the 6-yard line. 40 yards on the punt. Cody Bliss pins Mississippi State deep. Lamel Ages got back there to down that ball at the 7-yard line. First and 10 for State when we return. First and 10 from its own 7 following the punt from Cody Bliss, and Lamel Ages hustling downfield, downing the ball in the 7. You see Kevin Fant, who coming into this afternoon's action, State was averaging 256 yards per game in the air. And Auburn, for the most part, has held Mississippi State's offense in check.
They really have, and only 6 completions out of 14 attempts for 49 yards with a long of 32. In the first half, and Kevin Fant, those are not Fant-like numbers.
No.
And he's had really a marvelous senior year, especially, Andy, in light of the fact that Mississippi State is 2-4. I mean, you've got to really put a lot on your shoulders as a quarterback when your team is trying to move the ball offensively, and you're really not getting much benefit out of defensive football because your defense isn't giving you turnovers and they're not giving you good field position.
Charlie, so much State has had to come play from behind this season and really have had no other choice but to try and score quickly, and as a result they've gone to the passing game. I mean, they were down big against Oregon, came back and made a game of that. They were down big early at Houston, came back and almost won there. And they're down big today, 38-7 with 10:27 to go in the third. Fant on the rollout, gets some pressure, throws, complete. Complete to the tight end, Aaron Lumpkin. Junior Rose Green on the stop. It's a first down for Mississippi State.
Well-designed pass, little crossing route. Lumpkin started on the left side, and a little fake to the left by Fant. Lumpkin comes on a crossing route back to the right. Kevin Fant stops, does a nice job of delivering the ball in the seam. And Lumpkin, Andy, had 2 touchdown catches against Memphis last week. First time that a tight end for Mississippi State's had 2 touchdowns in the same game ever, I think.
Turner trying to get to the outside, does, and gets out of bounds. Auburn brought Travis Williams on the blitz, but he got pinned inside, and Turner was able to bounce it to the outside and get 7 yards on the play.
you know, you worry a little bit about your intensity if you're Gene Chizik and you're Auburn's defensive coach and you've seen Mississippi State, other than one play, the long touchdown by Nick Turner, struggling through the first half. You wonder if your team coming out is going to have that same kind of intensity defensively in the second half.
Auburn is being charged with a timeout. And I'm not sure if it was an equipment problem. One, yeah, I think Carlos Rogers, and that's Junior Rosegreen, and maybe with a chin strap broke or something like that, and Auburn is charged a timeout. It is Rosegreen. You see Frank Cox, Auburn's longtime equipment manager, working on the helmet of Junior Rosegreen.
Well, the equipment has evolved to really great links in football. You know, the science that goes into protecting these players and keeping the equipment very light and keeping the players mobile so that they can continue to do the things that they do on the field. It's really remarkable what these companies have come up with. And of course, Frank Cook is one of the best equipment managers in the country, and he's been at it a long, long time. Frank Cox, I should say. Sorry about that, Frank.
I'm wondering if June, maybe the visor, you know, so many times you see players wear the visors now, and I wonder if that may have come dislodged or something like that. Not that it makes a whole lot of difference right now.
You know, most people haven't ever felt a helmet with or without a visor, but it adds a lot of weight to that helmet because the visor has to be very, you know, sturdy, as you can imagine, and it makes the helmet much heavier. Of course, the players get used to it continually wearing it.
Second and three in state, I think, moved. I think it was the left guard, Will Rogers, is who the Auburn defensive linemen were pointing at. And Rosegreen is back on the field.
And you see Auburn's number 83, Jayton Ratliff, here as Duel.
Foul is a dead ball. False start by the offense. Penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot with a repeat of the second.
As Duel Jackson, rather, the referee gives us the call. But Jay Ratliff, this is the first game that he's been back, and it's good to have him back because he's been really missed by the Auburn defense.
Yeah, injured early in the Georgia Tech game. His first action since. Busted play. Fant in some trouble. Now trying to scramble. Down he goes, Will Herring, coming up from his safety spot to make the stop for Auburn. Fant turned one way. Turner, the tailback, went the other.
Yeah, this is one where one of them went the wrong way, and it looked like Kevin Fant because the entire offensive line went one way, and the running back, Nick Turner, went the same way to the right. Fant came out to the left, and he got drilled on the sideline after he made that play. Uh-oh, you're in trouble there.
Yes, you are. Kevin Sears giving chase, and then you'll see Herring come up to –
and he thought he was hit out of bounds, but he actually wasn't. Carlos Rogers gave him a good shot right on the backside. That'll be sore tomorrow.
Third and 10 for Mississippi State. One of eight on third down today. Fant flushed again. That's got to be a hold. He looks and he throws deep for Lumpkin, the tight end. It's incomplete and a flag down. They're going to get Auburn for an interference. Jay Ratliff got absolutely tackled in the backfield. You tell me how you don't call this.
I don't know. I mean, everybody in the stands saw that, but Will Herring, the safety, has to turn around and find the football. That is a good call on the interference because you can't just keep running and not look back for the football and
face
guard with the receiver. Hopefully we'll get a shot at this, but as Kevin Fant was looking for somebody downfield, one of the linemen just absolutely held Jay Ratliff.
Yeah. There's no question that was interference on Herring, but it should be offsetting penalties because Ratliff absolutely got tackled, and it happened in front of the official.
And here we'll see it. There he is. You see the arm of the defender or the offensive lineman is just taking him down. Now, there's no way he ran him down from the backside. But here is where Will Herring has to turn around, and the big tight end, Lumpkin, was open downfield.
Fant's going to have to throw this one away. Travis Williams and Reggie Torbor introduced themselves to Fant, who rolled out of the pocket. And if you get out of the pocket and you want to throw it away, you still have to get it across the line of scrimmage. I'll tell you what, Fant, you know, this is a team that came in Charlie, and given up 18 sacks, and Auburn has put pressure on Fant all day long.
They really have, and the offensive line has seen a quicker Auburn defense get around a much heavier, larger offensive line.
Second and 10 from the 38 for Mississippi State. Fant steps and he throws Lumpkin, the tight end, to the 46-yard line. We'll update you on some SEC scores. A final score to report, Ole Miss 43 over Alabama 28. In the fourth quarter, Georgia starting to pull away from Vanderbilt 20-2. And in the second quarter play, Arkansas 7, Florida 3.
Well, that's going to be a good game because really Arkansas doesn't defend the pass as well as they defend the run. And with Leak at quarterback, Chris Leak, the freshman quarterback in Florida, they're going to be throwing the ball all over the field in Fayetteville.
Third and two for State. Well, Auburn's got everybody bunched up at the line of scrimmage. Fant rolls, got his fullback open. Now steps and throws, incomplete, intended for the tight end Lumpkin. Auburn did a good job of disguising the coverage there, Charlie.
Well, they really did, and Lumpkin, the tight end, was trying to get out. And of course, with a third down and short in the triple I set, they had what looked to be a power play set up, and then Kevin Fant did a good job hiding the football, but Auburn really got after Fant, did not let him set and throw the ball. Last time that the punt was made, a 59-yard punt by Robert Wallace.
Trey Smith in some traffic, and he goes down at the 13, make that the 12-yard line. A 8:24 to go in the third. Auburn 38, Mississippi State 7. Andy Burcham, Charlie Trotman, our entire CSS crew at Jordan-Hare Stadium on a glorious fall afternoon. Campbell, the handoff to Brandon Jacobs. Taken down at the 15-yard line. That's a great tackle by Darren Williams. That's a big gainer if number 22 doesn't get to Brandon Jacobs.
You know, Darren Williams has done this two or three times to Brandon Jacobs. Looks like Brandon Jacobs is getting out to the open field and going to really be able to turn the jet zone, but Williams does a super job of getting in there, making the tackle around the ankles.
Second down and six from the 18 for Auburn. Again, Jacobs to the corner and taken out of bounds at the 17-yard line by T.J. Mawinney.
That's good gang tackling, and that's what you have to do against Brandon Jacobs is get over there and gang tackle him. Number 53, Mawinney, the senior leader of this defense. We haven't really heard a lot about him today. He hasn't been as active as he normally is, but Brandon Jacobs, 107 yards, 17 carries, and that has Auburn with two backs again over 100 yards.
Carnell Williams with 154 and five touchdowns in the first half alone. State shows blitz, brings all three linebackers. Auburn picks it up. Campbell throws to Silas Daniels, and he's got the first down. Well, Auburn did a good job of picking up the blitz, and Campbell got the ball away in a hurry, and Daniels got to the sticks and got the first down.
Silas Daniels with 10 catches coming into the game. That's his 11th catch on the year. He's had some big catches. Remember the catch he had in the middle of the field between the hashes last week against Arkansas to set Auburn up for their a field goal that gave him the 7-point cushion. And Silas Daniels doing a good job, the junior out of Jacksonville, Florida.
At the 25, first down for Auburn. The draw to Brandon Jacobs. Head down for 9 yards to the 34. Mawinney leading the charge for Mississippi State along with Darren Williams.
You know, the feeling you get in nice draw here, Campbell leaving it with Brandon Jacobs, follows his blockers well. Auburn doing a good job getting a hat on a lot of people, a lot of those Bulldog defenders, but you keep getting the feeling that sooner or later Brandon Jacobs is going to break out into the open and be able to use that speed.
Second down for the Tigers. Jacobs in some traffic, and he's going to lose a couple yards on the play.
Oh, outstanding defense that time. The left defensive side of the line just overcame the Auburn right offensive side, and just that's about a two-yard loss on that play, and nowhere to go. Good defense that time by Mississippi State.
And Auburn looks at third down and four as Jason Campbell gets the signal from the sideline. Clock rolls down inside 6:15 to go in this third quarter of play. 38-7 Auburn. Wallace, the man in motion. Campbell with the pitch to Brandon Jacobs. Trying to get to the outside, does, and drags tacklers across the 35 to the 36.
And that's what you get with Brandon Jacobs, because he's got the speed to get to the outside, but watch when he catches this tall sweep. He's thinking about cutting up right there, but he decides to go ahead and go to the outside, and Cooper Wallace does a good job maintaining his block. If he had not maintained that block for as long as he did, then I don't think that Brandon Jacobs would have been able to get to that corner, and certainly not the first down.
Jacobs out, Trey Smith in at tailback for Auburn. From the 36, Trey with his carry to the corner. Still going. Look at Trey Smith. Hey, if big number 27 can do it, so can I, to the 49. You know that Trey's just been chomping at the bit to get out there at the tailback spot.
His average isn't what the other tailbacks are, because their averages are more around 5 yards a carry. On the season, Trey Smith only at 3 yards, but that's because Auburn has really used Trey Smith in those short yardage situations at the goal line, because he's got that great leaping ability to get up and over the pile.
Now, he had four touchdowns, or has four touchdowns. Campbell throws. Jake Slaughter has it. His leg's taken out from under him at the 45 by Kevin Dockery, who had a career-best 12 tackles against Vanderbilt earlier this season. And what was Mississippi State's first of two straight wins, winning against Memphis last week. Auburn on a four-game win streak coming into play today.
Auburn's got a nice drive going. No points scored in the second half by either team. Auburn still with a huge 38-7 lead.
Campbell to Trey Smith. Weaves his way inside the 45-yard line. Is there a ball down? That's a fumble, and State's got it. I'll be darned. Willie Evans recovered the fumble.
Willie Evans for Mississippi State.
Well, it happened deep inside the pile, because from the stands and from certainly the press box, you could not see the ball come out. And we'll see the replay here. And the ball given to Trey Smith. Got the ball, puts it away. But somewhere down in there, oh, the ball was just taken from him.
Yeah, Willie Evans just
took the ball from him. As he was falling to the ground. It was not fumbled, it was just taken from him.
So State with the ball in good field position at its own 45. Play action, Fant in trouble. He causes the football. It's loose, and DeMarco McNeil has it. Actually, that was Murphy with the recovery for Auburn. I think McNeil may have caused the fumble. Well, Auburn gets the ball right back. This is a good defensive play by Auburn.
Well, only one turnover in the first half, but both teams turned the ball over in successive plays, and DeMarco McNeil and Brett Evans were sandwiching Kevin Fant. Kevin Fant fumbled the football, and Auburn's Dexter Murphy, the senior out of LaGrange, Georgia, gets the fumble recovery, and now Auburn set up right at the 30-yard line of Mississippi State.
Jacobs back in at tailback for Auburn. Play action, Campbell looks to go. He's got Cooper Wallace, and he dropped a touchdown pass at the 5-yard line. Oh, that's six if he holds on to the football. Boy, that's well executed except the catch.
Jason Campbell had two people wide open for a touchdown. He had Cooper Wallace in the middle, and he had Trey Smith up to the left side. Nobody covered Trey Smith either.
Oh.
And Cooper Wallace wishes he had that one back.
You can bet your life on that one.
You see Cooper Wallace just start on the seam route right down the hash marks. Ball thrown perfectly. He would have just waltzed into the end zone and just could not quite hang on to that one.
Mm. Second down from the 31 for Auburn. Jacobs. hurdles near the 25.
You see, what I was talking about with Brandon Jacobs is Brandon Jacobs, as Mawinney makes another tackle, he looked like he wasn't going to gain anything, goes up, and just his body length when he falls forward was a five or six yard gain on the play.
It was 6 yards, and it's third and four for Auburn at the 25. Obamanu and Taylor are the wide receivers. The play action and the rollout by Campbell. Steps and throws. Great pass. Taylor has it inside the 10. You talk about a thread the needle job from Jason Campbell to Courtney Taylor.
An 18-yard game.
18 yards and a first down for Auburn.
And again, off the play action. Little fake to Brandon Jacobs. And Campbell sets up, throws a just a beautiful spiral to Courtney Taylor on the right sideline. And it looked like Auburn had one of the tight ends over there, Cole Bennett, a little bit too close to Courtney Taylor, but didn't get in the way, and Courtney Taylor makes a great catch.
And Carnell Williams is in at tailback for Auburn. You look at the day that Jason Campbell has had, very efficient. Carnell Williams down near the 6. Remember, Williams has 5 touchdowns today. Another would break the Auburn record. He now shares the record with Joe Cribbs, set in 1978 against Vanderbilt.
Well, and it, you know, makes you obviously know that the coaches are aware of that. The coaches want to get this record for the efforts that Carnell Williams has made today, and obviously for that offensive line, because they'd love to know that they were part of that record.
Second and 6 for Auburn. Carnell cuts it. 6 touchdowns, an Auburn record for Carnell Williams.
And look at the offensive lineman over there congratulating Carnell, because big Troy Reddick, big Mark Pera, Danny Lindsay, and Monrico Crittenden all in there doing a great job with Stephen Ross, giving him really free reign until he got to about the 2-yard line. Then Carnell just busted it on in the end zone.
44-7 Auburn. Yost on to attempt the extra point. Down and it is good. And with 3:01 to go in the third quarter, Auburn's only score of the second half breaks the school record.
Little ground level shot of the touchdown there. You see Carnell struggling to get to about the 2-yard line. He just fights his way on in, but nobody touches him, as we see from behind the run. Great block by Jake Slaughter opening it up. And then Carnell, after Birdsong gets him around the ankle, around the thighs, just forces his way on into the end zone. 6 touchdowns for the culmination of, I think, we think it's going to be the culmination for Carnell Williams today of an unbelievably record-setting rushing performance.
What a day for Carnell. That record stood since 1978 for Joe Cribbs. And remember, Carnell had tied it before the first half came to a close.
Five touchdowns for Carnell. Brandon Jacobs also over 100 yards, 123 yards, excuse me, 6 touchdowns. Yep, 6 touchdowns for Carnell. And 161 yards on 15 carries for Auburn's brilliant tailback. Mm.
Yost to kick off. Reed and Turner to return for state if they're given the opportunity. A 45-7 Auburn lead against Mississippi State. No chance. With the wind, Yost puts it 5 yards out of the back of the end zone. Been a good day for Yost, who has a 45-yard field goal. He's been perfect on his extra points and perfect on his kickoffs as well. I think he's only allowed 1 kickoff return here this afternoon for Philip Yost.
And a lot of people don't realize how big that is, but when you've got kick returners like Mississippi State has, you don't want them on the field, you don't want the ball in their hands, and you certainly don't want to get them started upfield. So It puts them back on the 20-yard line. They have to go all 80 yards to score, and that's certainly the way you want to put your defense on the field.
3:01 remaining in the third. The pitch to Turner, trying to get to the corner. Turns it upfield, and Turner gets a couple, and that's about all. Rashard Gilliard out of Jacksonville, Florida, a freshman All-SEC selection for Auburn back in 2000, comes up and makes the stop for Auburn.
You know, Rashard Gilliard's made a lot of big plays for Auburn over his career. Senior out of Montgomery, and 5'10", 208-pounder. Auburn proud to have guys like Rashard Gilliard on the team.
Gain of three for Turner, second down at the 23. Turner again, able to cut it up. He gets the first down across the 30 to the 31. Mayo Sowell, freshman All-American for Auburn two seasons ago, makes the stop. Remember, Jarius Norwood, the starting tailback for State, went out in the first half. Nick Turner has filled in admirably for the Bulldogs since.
Well, admirably is an understatement. I mean, 70-yard-plus touchdown run against the Auburn defense put Mississippi State back in the game early on, and since then it's been all Auburn.
From the 31, Turner again. He gets three on the play out to the 34-yard line. Tim Duckworth, a freshman out of Taylorsville, Mississippi, makes the stop. A lot of Mississippi and Alabama connections between these two teams.
You know, Mississippi State, it's going to be interesting to see during the offseason with Mississippi State what happens you look at Nick Turner here, the day he's having 106 yards with 11 rushes, so he's averaging right at 10 yards per carry. And that's another big day for the tailbacks, although it was Norwood last week and the week before had the big days.
Second down and six, Turner again. Nice cutback for Nick Turner. Trying to get out and finally taken down at the 47-yard line by Lamel Ages. But it is a first down for Mississippi State.
And that was a good recovery by Lamel Ages, because had he not gotten off his block, and maybe had Turner not stumbled a little bit, this could have been another huge run. Watch the move to the outside right here. And then, look, Turner starts to stumble a little bit, but Lamel Ages gets off of his block and turns what could have been a huge gain into just a nice first down run.
Turner gets a breather, and Fred Reed is back in at tailback for State. Auburn brings the blitz. Reed tries to bounce it out, cuts it across midfield into Auburn territory. Donnie Young with some help from Lamel Ages on the stop for Auburn, and the Mississippi State player is slow to get up. It's one of the wide receivers, Omar Connor, in what may have been the final play of the third quarter, down to 19 seconds to go. See Ronnie Brown. Doesn't look like we're going to see Ronnie here today. He's didn't even have his shoulder pads on, sitting next to Carnell Williams there. There's Ronnie. Hopefully back for LSU next week in Baton Rouge. And the third quarter does come to a close as Fant just behind the third quarter gun. The only score of the third quarter, a record breaker by Carnell Williams, his sixth touchdown of the day. The Tigers go into the fourth quarter up 45-7.
This is a practical world, and that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe in honesty and truthfulness.
I believe in a sound mind.
In a sound body.
I believe in a spirit that is not afraid.
I believe in the human touch.
I believe in my country.
And because Auburn men
and women
believe in these things,
I believe in Auburn and love it.
To 45-7, Auburn leads as we head to the fourth quarter. Andy Burks and Charlie Trotman with you from Jordan-Hare Stadium. We've talked so much about the Auburn offense, and the numbers are really startling. But, Charlie, for the most part, Auburn's defense has done the job today as well.
Well, they've still held the Mississippi State offense under 200 yards. An offense is averaging right at 400 yards. Of course, we're just going into the fourth quarter. Kevin Fant is the one that has really been held in check. 9 out of 20 for only 73 yards on the day.
45-7 Auburn with Feline. Glad you joined us today live on pay-per-view throughout the Southeast. I know there are Auburn clubs that have gathered for today's game at various restaurants around the Southeast to watch it. All right. Thanks and War Eagle to you. Second and 5 for State from the 48. Reed stacked up at the line of scrimmage. He maybe got a yard, and that's about all. Sowell out of Shades Valley High in Birmingham on the stop for Auburn.
Mayo Sowell, Donnay Young, and Dexter Murphy, all three in there on the tackle there. Doing a good job keeping Fred Reed corralled. That's what you've got to do against these tailbacks, is you've got to keep them corralled. You can't let the speed that Mississippi State has in the backfield get into the open field, as we saw earlier with Turner.
In the second quarter in Fayetteville in Florida, on top of Arkansas, 13-7. Third and 4 for State. Fant to throw. Has a man open, dropped. Pass intended for McKinley Scott. And State is now 1 of 10 on third down today. You look on the other side of the ledger, Auburn 7 of 11 on third down.
You know, every now and then, a quarterback who may have a hot streak may run into a day where he's just not performing the way that he normally performs. Kevin Fant, on that particular occasion, just threw a bad pass. Ball was thrown just a little short and of its intended target, and that's not normally what you see out of the senior quarterback.
Fourth down and 4, State to punt it away. Off the side of the foot, Trey Smith comes up and takes the punt. And a nice return by Smith across the 21-yard line. Nick Signego with the stop for Mississippi State.
Well, I'm glad you had to say that, and yeah. I did. That's a tough name to call, but Trey Smith did a good job on that particular punt return, because as he caught the ball, he was running full speed to his left, this near sideline, and he had to catch it in stride while he was about to be hit, and he knew he was going to take that lick. A bobble right there, and that's a fumble on the punt return above. But Trey Smith
Sullivan
did a good job.
Quarterback for Auburn. Excuse me, Charlie. Ben Grubbs in motion for the Tigers. Sullivan hands off to Brandon Jacobs, who fumbles the football. Sullivan recovers it with a flag down on the play.
Well, flags were thrown on both sidelines at the line of scrimmage by both linesmen. So we'll see what the call is. Looks like they're talking to Mississippi State. So let's see what the call is.
Foul is an illegal formation by the offense. That is declined. Will be second down.
So Auburn loses yardage on the fumble and then the recovery.
You know, a long time ago, Andy, there weren't that many formations. You know, now there's so many different formations, it's even tough on the officials to find out which one or discern which one may be an illegal formation.
Second and 15, Sullivan to throw, and it's picked off. An interception by Mississippi State down to the 13-yard line. Eric Fuller with the pick for the Bulldogs.
This looks like a bad pass, but Andy, I think it's miscommunication between the wide receiver and the quarterback. Watch at the top of the screen. The receiver is going to run an out route, and instead, I think Josh Sullivan thought that Silas Daniels was going to run a curl, a little button hook, and he was throwing the ball where he thought Silas Daniels was going to stop and turn and face him. Instead, he went to the sideline and left Fuller there all by himself for the pick.
State with the ball, first and 10 from the Auburn 13. Nick Turner, the tailback. He will get the carry. Turner, head down and taken out of bounds at the 10. He got 3 yards on the play. Mayo Sowell has had a big second half for Auburn. He makes the stop.
I tell you, Mayo Sowell could start for a lot of teams, because he's behind Carlos Dansby, Dontarius Thomas, and Travis Williams. But Mayo Sowell makes play after play after play out of Shades Valley High School in Birmingham, 6'1", 230-pound junior, and he is a good football player. I mean, he would start for a lot of teams in this conference.
Mississippi State will call a timeout with a second and 7 play coming up from the Auburn 10. 13:27 to go in the fourth. Tigers up 45-7. Bell Tower at Sanford. Well, that isn't Sanford Hall, is it? 13:27 to go in the fourth, 45-7. Auburn on top. Scores in the SEC. Finals to report. Ole Miss over Alabama, 43-28. Georgia beat Vandy, 27-8.
Sounds like Vandy improved a little bit. Georgia had such a shellacking win at Knoxville last week against Tennessee with all the turnovers that Tennessee had, that I'm sure Georgia could have easily overlooked Vanderbilt, but Bobby Johnson obviously got his team up to play and held Georgia under 30 points. That was probably a pretty good outing for them.
In the second quarter, Florida leads at Arkansas 13-7. Miami a winner today over Temple 52-14. Purdue upsetting Wisconsin 26-23. Fant back, throws that ball, was hit the line. Fant hit as he let loose the ball. Michigan State upsets Minnesota 44-38. Nebraska beat Texas A&M 48-12 as we take another look. Who gets to Fant here? Is it Derek Graves? Yeah, it's Derek Graves, the former tailback.
Yeah, Derek Graves from Holt, Alabama, close to Tuscaloosa. Auburn very glad in that recruiting battle they were able to get Derek Graves to come to Auburn, and he is steadily improving at the outside linebacker position.
He's already made a start this season. Staten a four wide set on third and seven. And State ran out of time.
I think Kevin Fant is talking to Doyle Jackson and saying that the clock
delay
had not started.
By the offense,
yeah.
Penalty 5 yards from the previous spot. Replaying third down.
Jackie Sherrill is 5 yards out on the field talking with Fant there.
Well, those are the kind of things you hate as a head coach because it's just an unnecessary penalty. And again, you know, the play clock, they're yet to call the play in the huddle. The play clock is at 12. They're just now breaking the huddle. The play's going to be at 8, 7, 6.
Play clock at 3. Fant out of the gun, throwing to the end zone, has a man open, and it is incomplete. Donnie Young really made up some ground on the play. Play intended for Ray Bivens. Actually, that was Jenkins, and Donnie Young got back and with some closing speed was able to knock that ball away.
Well, it was a beautiful route by Jenkins because Jenkins was open. There's Sears, Kevin Sears, getting close to Fant. And Jenkins, I think, got his hands on that one, but Donnie Young was closing the gap, as you said, Andy, very quickly. This is a ball thrown to the back of the end zone, route run, a corner route to the back of the end zone, and a near miss.
Fourth and 12 for Mississippi State. Fant throws. It is incomplete. In and out of the hands of Ray Bivens. Rashard Gilyard made the stick at the end zone, and Auburn takes over on downs.
Man-to-man coverage, and Rashard Gilyard does a good job getting close to Ray Bivens. This is just a slant route. Ball's thrown perfectly, a little bit high, And Rashard Gilyard got his arms in there to knock the ball down. And we'll see another view of it here. Fant throwing the slant route. Bivens looks like he has it. And the ball was knocked out of his hands and hit the ground as he was coming down.
Huh. But did he cross the plane of the end zone with the ball?
Yeah, if he crossed the plane, had possession. But you got to remember, you don't have possession until you get your feet down on the ground. It can't be in a midair catch. You have to plant your feet.
Brandon Jacobs on the first down carry for Auburn. Rumbles across the 22-yard line. Another look. Fant to Bivens. Does he have possession when he comes down with the ball?
He's got it right there. He's got his foot down. Did he cross the plane? They may have an argument there.
You're right.
They certainly may have an argument. That's one of those plays that is a bang bang play, and it, you know, official right there on it. But that could have been a Mississippi State touchdown.
Second down and five. Jacobs out to the 25-yard line. Jermaine Johnson on the stop for State.
You know, you got to give Bivens on that catch a lot of credit for going up and catching the ball. I thought that ball had been thrown a little better by Kevin Fant. It actually was a little high and a little bit behind Bivens. And when he caught that ball, he did a good job coming down and just didn't quite hold on to it for the call. But again, it could have been a touchdown anyway, just didn't get the call.
To the 26 on the first down for the Tigers. Jacobs bounces to the outside. He gets 3 or 4 yards on the play. Jeremy Johnson on the stop for Mississippi State.
Auburn on offense nearing the 500-yard mark in total offense on the day. And over 330 yards on the ground so far for Auburn.
Charlie, Auburn came in averaging 357 in total offense.
Total
a
offense. And has gotten that, almost nearly gotten that, on the ground.
Second and seven with Jacobs in motion. They hand off to Jake Slaughter. Auburn's backup fullback gets across the 30-yard line.
Boy, that's a rare carry for the Auburn fullbacks, because on the year, Brandon Johnson has only one carry and Jake Slaughter had only three carries. So that's about the fifth carry for the fullback on the year.
Well,
Auburn.
A carry for the fullback and a couple catches for Brandon Johnson at fullback today.
Yeah, big day. And Brandon Johnson made so many good blocks. And a lot of those yards that you see that were racked up by Cornell Williams and continually by Brandon Johnson, Jacobs, because of Brandon Johnson's
third
block.
And four, and Jacobs is wrapped up and loses a yard on the play. He may lose a couple yards on the play, as a matter of fact. Roosevelt Tate out of Hamilton High in Memphis made the stop for State. Backup offense unable to move the football here.
Later on, you're going to see Brandon Johnson probably the answer to a trivia question as who was the guy leading and opening those holes for the tailbacks at Auburn, Cornell Williams and Brandon Jacobs. It was Brandon Johnson, just so valuable to this Auburn offense.
Cody Bliss to punt it away. Nick Turner to receive. Bliss. Wobbly punt, Turner from the 33-yard line. Flag is down as Turner is taken down on the play. Brandon Jacobs reaches down and just picks him up.
Well, and it was Jairus McIntyre who was held. Number 81 for Auburn came off the field, and his shoulder pad was exposed because obviously his jersey was pulled over his shoulder pad. And State will get hit with another penalty. And again, Andy, another punt where you see a hold. It's very rare if you do not see the yellow hanky on a punting play.
The foul is holding by the returning team during the return. Penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the hole, followed by a first down.
10:03 to go in the fourth quarter. Tigers comfortably in front of Mississippi State, 45-7.
Cardinal nothing. At the half, the Ohio selected to the second annual Capital One Mascot All-America team. Aubie is fighting for the National Mascot of the Year versus the likes of Harry Dog of Georgia, Scratch from Kentucky, and Smokey from Tennessee. To vote for Aubie, visit www.capitalonebowl.com once a day. Number 17, Kyle York, in at quarterback for Mississippi State.
Yeah! 45-7, Auburn, just over 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, and Mississippi State will go to its backup quarterback. You take a look at Kyle York, 6'2", 207, a sophomore from Spring, Texas, out of the Houston area. 2 for 9 on the year for 17 yards for York. Auburn did a good job against Kevin Fant this afternoon. Fant 9 of 21 on the afternoon for State. York from the gun. Sets and throws, complete to Jenkins. Jenkins across the 35-yard line. Looks like he has enough for the first down to the 37. Derek Graves and Monte Pitts on the stop for Auburn.
Nice release, very quick on his setup and release out of the shotgun. Kyle York caught the ball and delivered it very quickly on a 5-yard hitch route. Watch how quickly that he gets rid of the ball. Wham, nice throw right in the chest. And good first down.
Actually just shy of the first down, second down. York again to throw, has to step up in the pocket and dives for the first down for Mississippi State out to the 39-yard line. Tim Duckworth got to York, but not before he had a first down, and a State player is down in the play. One of the offensive linemen, I believe, for Mississippi State, lying on his side at the 34-yard line.
Well, you don't want to see this with the game, with the score, what it is, Auburn with the big lead. You don't want to see anybody get hurt. You hate to see a Mississippi State lineman down, because that's really where Mississippi State has been making their hay in this season. Coming in at 2-4 is the offense that's been really the catalyst in the two wins that they've had in the last 2 weeks. And, of course, Auburn doing a good job on that, getting T.J. Jackson and Duckworth, Tim Duckworth, in there on York, and York scrambled, got his first down, and it'll be a first down for Mississippi State with about 9 minutes, 20 seconds.
It's Blake Jones, Charlie, the starting center that gets up and is helped off the field, a guy that came to Mississippi State as a walk-on. He's from Athens, Alabama, and has worked his way into the starting lineup as a senior at 6'2", 290. And Chris McNeil will check in. 6'3", 287-pound sophomore checks in now at center for Mississippi State.
First and 10 at the 39.
Bulldogs scrimmage first and 10 from their own 39-yard line. Wallace, or rather York, to throw across the middle. Jenkins is wide open. The first down to the Auburn 38-yard line. Gilliard made the stop, but not before Jenkins gets it into Auburn territory.
And that'll show you a little bit about Justin Jenkins and how dangerous he is. Got good size, 6'1", 210, goes across the middle, catches the ball nicely, and a big game for the State offense. And Justin Jenkins is going to get some of those stats that he normally has, week in and week out here in the fourth quarter, it looks like.
From the Auburn 38, first down, York. With some time, throws it. Jenkins has got it at the 17-yard line. Gilliard again on the stop against the Auburn second-string defense. And State going with a no huddle. Well, actually, they will huddle it up.
And Jenkins took a big shot by Rashard Gilliard. And he was a little bit slow getting back to the huddle, but York looks very confident at quarterback, doing a good job. Kyle York. Two strong deliveries over the middle successively to Justin Jenkins, and it looks like Mississippi State may take a timeout.
They are indeed with 8:23 to go in the fourth quarter. Mississippi State looking at first down and 10 at the Auburn 17-yard line with the clock stopped. Jackie Sherrill announcing his retirement on effective at the end of this season. In his 26th year as a head coach on the collegiate level, a record of 180, 114, and 4, and in his 13th year at Mississippi State with a record of 75, 69, and 2.
You know, a lot of people watching the broadcast, Andy, might say, well, why was Kevin Fant not able to move Mississippi State down the field as easily as it looks like Kyle York is doing? But you got to remember, Auburn came in, obviously, with a strategy on defense of not allowing Kevin Fant any time to make decisions. They came with blitzes. They came with a lot of pressure early on, trying to set the tone of the ball game defensively against the Mississippi State offense. And right now, I think Auburn is resigned to just play really a base defense against Kyle York and just react to the ball. So I think that's what's going on right now. So people might wonder why Kyle York is getting so much more time to throw than Kevin Fant had.
8:23 to go in the fourth quarter. The Tigers leading the Bulldogs 45-7. First down, York throws. It's across the middle. It's to Justin. It's a touchdown for Mississippi State to Justin Jenkins. Well, Kyle York had no trouble moving the football down the field, did he?
He really didn't. And Auburn did come with an outside linebacker blitz on the left side that time, but the perfect play was called right where the blitz came from. You'll see it coming from the right side of the screen. And Justin Jenkins ran the slant route just on the inside of that. Nice move around Donnie Young, Auburn's free safety, and he dives into the end zone for the second touchdown on the afternoon for the Bulldog offense.
State will go for two with 8:15 to go in the fourth. 45-13 Auburn lead. State's about to run out of time there. I got to run the timeout on a two-point conversion. Gives you a chance to update a score that's very important to Auburn fans, to be sure. At the half, Arkansas on top of Florida, 13-7.
And, you know, I've wondered whether Arkansas would be a little bit down after the undefeated season came to a halt against Auburn. They were ranked number 7, had an awful lot going for them. Home field wins came very easily in Fayetteville. They had a 31-5 record at home until Auburn was able to win the game last week. And I had said earlier in the week it would not surprise me if Florida, throwing the ball the way they do, had a pretty good game against Arkansas.
Well, and let me, I think I gave the wrong score. I think it was just the opposite. I think Florida is on top 13-7.
Florida is on top 13-7. And again, it's going to be a game that probably goes down to the wire, but that's one of the things that Arkansas does not do as well, is they defend the run much, much better than they defend the pass.
Well, it looks like Ole Miss remains unbeaten in the SEC with the win over Alabama today. Auburn, it certainly looks like the Tigers will remain unbeaten in the SEC as well here today. And off course, Auburn goes to LSU next week in a 6:45 Central Time start in Baton Rouge. Two-point conversion to Jenkins, and it's knocked away. Right, nice play there by Montavis Pitts out of Lochapoca. So the score remains 45-13 with 8:15 to go in the fourth quarter. The
good
shadows
play.
Start to go across the playing surface here.
Just a fade route thrown to the outside, and Pitts gets his left arm up and just knocks the ball away from Jenkins. And this is just the fade route thrown to the outside, and what a nice reaction that time. Staying away from the interference call, not getting his right arm in there, and Monte Pitts gets his left arm up, knocks the ball away, and makes a nice play and does not allow the two-point conversion.
8:15 remaining in this one. Tigers up 45-13.
Yeah. Auburn goes to LSU next week in what's certainly going to be one of the big showdowns in the SEC West. And Andy, LSU will play South Carolina later on tonight in Columbia. And a lot of people have said that due to the fact that LSU has some injuries in their running back core, that they're not certain that LSU is going to get out of Columbia with a W tonight.
It will not be an easy one for LSU tonight. Brent Smith with the kickoff. Trey Smith will down.
Down to the upper by Trey Smith for the touchdown.
And that certainly has turned out to be a great new rivalry over the last 10 or 15 years. You know, for a while, Auburn didn't play LSU. And LSU was not on the schedule during the late 70s and early part of the 80s, only a couple of times here and there. But LSU, because they're in the SEC West, a year in and year out foe for Auburn, and a game that Auburn fans always look forward to going to Baton Rouge.
Trey Smith, the lone back for the Tigers, in a double tight end set. Takes the handoff from Sullivan. Smith is out to the 25-yard line. He gets 5 yards on the play. Kenny Kern on the stop for Mississippi State.
Auburn's got a lot of fresh faces in the game right now. And got left tackle in there, Drew Kirk, the sophomore out of Greenville, Georgia.
Lee Guess is in at wide receiver for the Tigers. Trey Smith takes the carry for about a yard.
Thomas Anderson, the big offensive guard, the 6'7", 320-pound junior out of Bessemer, Alabama, getting some playing time in there for the Tigers. And Josh Sullivan calling the signals. And, of course, at center is Jeremy Engel out of Montgomery, Alabama.
Third and four for Auburn. Smith again on the carry. He's shy of the first down.
Well, one thing that the Auburn offensive coaches, Hugh Nall, the offensive coordinator, Steve Ensminger, would certainly like to see is a little continuity develop here in the second half and in the fourth quarter with the Auburn offense. 6 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the game and counting, and the Auburn offense has been very ineffective here in the fourth quarter. They have not been able to knock out many first downs, and they've given Mississippi State some opportunities, and Mississippi State scored the last time they had it. Let's see what Cody Bliss does on this punt.
Nice punt. Certainly is, sending Turner back to the 20-yard line. Turner still on his feet and wrapped up. If you don't get him the first time, take him down the second time. Number 29, Derek Graves with the stop. 52 yards on the punt for Cody Bliss.
You know, Cody Bliss coming in and winning the job as a true freshman punter has done a great job. And what I like about Cody Bliss, Andy, is the hang time that he has on his punts. He really gets a lot of height, normally speaking, on the punts. And it gives Auburn's punt coverage team a good opportunity to get downfield and make the tackle.
Again, Kyle York at quarterback for State. With some time, throws to Jenkins, sliding catch at the Auburn 47-yard line for a first down.
And they're not doing anything unusual. The same exact play, they're running over and over and over. Jenkins lines up in the slot to the left, and he's just going down and running what's really just a seam route. And York is timing it. Nice catch in there by Jenkins.
Auburn not putting pressure right now on York. As he looks and he throws, and Jenkins has it. He's at the 26-yard line.
Now, that time they came with a little change of pace. Jenkins, the corner, or the slot receiver rather, he's been running right down the middle of the field getting open. This time he has a little hitch, goes to the outside on the flag route, and makes a nice catch. Donnie Young with a very vicious tackle on that play, but looks like State's going to get caught with the hold. Here's the call.
Is holding on the offense. Penalty is 10 yards from the previous spot, followed by a repeat of the first down.
Doyle Jackson, referee here this afternoon.
Yeah, nullifies a nice play by York. Kyle York, he's looking impressive at quarterback right now, doing a good job. Does not look like he's rattled whatsoever. Coming in, the sophomore out of Spring, Texas, 6 foot, 207, not a real tall quarterback, but it's got good size and delivers the ball nicely.
First and 20 from the 43. York in trouble. And he just got run over by Carol Derazan. Oh, man. Derazan just ran right through Kyle York. This is Kyle on Kyle.
Yeah, Kyle Derazan, now you're talking about a hard lick. Watch this tackle coming in. Wham! Man, I mean, not a wrap-up. That was just actually chest-to-chest, And Terazan wanted to make sure that people recognized that he was the one that made that tackle. Crowd gave a big whoa when he made that lick.
He's out of Morganza, Louisiana. Second and 29 now for State. York is flushed out of the pocket. Slides to the 45-yard line. Gets drilled on the play by Antares Williams. The last two plays, York has taken a couple pops.
Now watch York. He finds the soft spot. Auburn gets upfield and no one there to contain the run or the scramble straight ahead. And Antares Williams comes over and makes the tackle, sets up a third down and about 17 for the Mississippi State offense.
Need to get to the Auburn 37-yard line for the first down. The pass complete to Ray Bivens, but taken down at midfield by Rashard Gilliard.
Nice tackle. Good pass, good catch by Bivens. Again, he may have had a touchdown not given to him by the officials earlier on the fourth down play, but Rashard Gilliard, who was on him on that play as well, makes a nice tackle and sets up the fourth down.
Jared Cook will punt it away for State. Trey Smith back at the 10. Smith will watch this one go into the end zone on high. 3:25 to go in the third quarter. 45-13, Auburn on its way to its fifth consecutive victory. To go as Auburn is about to post its fifth consecutive victory after dropping the two games to USC and Georgia Tech. It's Brandon Jacobs on the carry, and he's wrestled to the turf at the 29-yard line by Brad Horton. Clock continues to roll down, and Charlie, last couple minutes of this one, I think you have to be impressed with the way Auburn came out. I mean, all the elements were there for a letdown, but we didn't see one this afternoon from Auburn.
We really didn't, and we saw Auburn take advantage of its running game and just pound Mississippi State's defense, and they got a huge production out of Cornell Williams and Brandon Jacobs in the first half. 35 first half points, or 38 first half points, most since a Vanderbilt game in
1990. Yeah. Kern and Swain bring down Jacobs after a first down carry from Brandon.
And Brandon Jacobs, he looks like he's sort of been running downhill all day long, he and Cornell Williams. And you've got to give all kind of credit to Auburn's offensive line because with 140 yards on 28 rushes, Cornell Williams over 160 yards on the day. You're talking about 300 yards between two backs. What a day for the Auburn offense.
Jacobs trying to add to that total. Out to the 37-yard line as we approach the two-minute mark. Mahwinney and Robinson, actually Kern and Robinson on the stop.
Hey, when Kirk just picked Brandon Jacobs up, Drew Kirk, who's 6'6 and 280, when he picked Brandon Jacobs up, Brandon Jacobs was just about as big as Auburn's right tackle on that play. He is a huge presence at tailback.
Second down and four for Auburn at the 38. Here's Jacobs again. Out to the 41, I believe, is where they'll give him progress. Jeremy Johnson on the stop for State.
And Jackie Sherrill announcing that he is not going to come back as Mississippi State's head coach. There'll be a lot of speculation in Starkville and around the SEC as to who may be named as the successor to Jackie Sherrill. Jackie Sherrill with 13 years as the head coach at Mississippi State. And it's hard to believe that no coach in Mississippi State history has ever been there longer than 13 years.
Third and one for Auburn. Jacobs bounces outside, and now it's a foot race. And Jacobs taken out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Johnson made the stop.
Well, this is what we've talked about, a little counterplay to the left and breaking it back over to the right is Brandon Jacobs, and he's in a foot race with number 34. That's Jermaine Johnson, who is the strong safety, and he catches him down inside the 30-yard line at about the 27, and a big run for Auburn's tailback.
Yeah, Jacobs gets a rest as Trey Smith is back out there for Auburn. First and 10 from the 27, and right up the gut, Jake Slaughter, the Auburn fullback.
Yeah, that's a little action at the bottom of the pile. We talked about that some this week. The Mississippi State has been known to be a little active at the bottom of those piles. And one of the Auburn linemen kind of tied up down in there right now, Calmoo Jackson.
Final seconds ticking away. Auburn will not have to run another play. And the Auburn Tigers have won their fifth consecutive game as the two teams converge onto the field. And Tommy Tuberville, for the final time, will walk across the field and shake hands with Jackie Sherrill. 9 seasons these guys have coached against each other, and this will be the final game as Auburn wins and goes to 5-2 on the season. Tigers at LSU next week. For Charlie Trotman and our entire CSS crew, Andy Burchin with your final again. Auburn 45, Mississippi State 13. So long from Jordan-Hare Stadium.